and passion and the culture, Caribbean blood. Now when time to come out all nation, to the team in a unification. When the stadium run beach at the grandstand, not the meaning of beautification.
It's how we play.
It's action time in the Republic Bank CPL 2023, match 26. We're in the business end of this tournament, live from the National Stadium in Providence, Guyana. It's the Amazon Warriors, the only unbeaten team in this competition, up against the St. Lucia Kings. So much action in this tournament. Teams fighting for a top four place so that they can battle for this trophy. Neither of these two teams have gotten their hands on it just yet, but that could change by the end of this year. Earlier we had the toss and it was Imran Tahir winning the toss and electing to bat first, wanting to challenge his team, of course, who have qualified for the top two. They've kept the same team in and a very strong batting lineup with depth. That will be their main feature in this first innings. Samuel Badger alongside me to talk us through the Kings side.
Hello, Nikhil. Hello, everyone. A couple of changes for the St. Lucia Kings. Rajapaksa in along with Mackenzie Clark. Colin Munro, the highest run scorer, overseas run scorer in the history of this tournament, along with Johnson Charles at the top of the order. They'll be important along with the left-handers through the middle to sort of dent the hopes of the Guyana Amazon Warriors. Mazari Joseph has been exceptional along with Matthew Ford in terms of dot ball percentage. So look out for them as well. Umpires making their way out. The helmet calm. You can see a different perspective in this year's edition of the RBL CPL. Leslie Reefer along with Dighton Butler. They'll be the on-field umpires and the men trusted with the responsibility of making those decisions. But Nikhil Uttamchandani, that decision to bowl to bat for the Guyana Amazon Warriors and to challenge their bowlers in the Duke. I quite like it. I think their decision-making has been quite sound this season. Rajapaksa with the gloves. But yeah, the dew last night was quite heavy. And that has taken the attention of quite a lot of the players. The commentators pick. These are your picks, Nikhil. Talk us through the reasons.
Yeah, there's green grass on that surface. Kemo Paul is one that they've identified to give more opportunities to. Azam kind of struggled, but I think he loves this stadium and I think this could be the night for him. And Sikandar Raza, well, going for the all-rounder and captain, makes his own decisions.
Yeah, that dew, as I was mentioning, quite heavy. So it'll give their bowlers an opportunity to experience that in the event that you're in a knockout situation and you have to bowl second. You have at least some level of experience. This man has been brilliant. In the last three games, he's registered consecutive half centuries. His strike rate, too, is really, really good. And a lot of their hopes will rest on his shoulders. He's been consistent. Matthew Nandu made his debut last night. A wonderful opening partnership along with Saim Ayub, 112. He looked quite composed and he looked really mature as well. Matthew Ford, I was mentioning his dot ball percentage is quite high, one of the highest this season. And he has an ability to swing this new ball. If he can get a wicket or two and put the Guyana Amazon Warriors batters under some pressure early, and then the St. Lucia Kings will be in this contest. But it's a good game. A really good matchup between these two teams. Almost set for the first ball. Historically, the Guyana Amazon Warriors have won 7 of the last 7 games played at this venue against this opposition. Can history be changed tonight?
Ford will try to angle it in and get it to go away from Ayub. Slip in place. Starts with a wide. Will be a tasty battle in this power play. Visit the Skyfair website for the best betting odds. Go to www.skyfair.vip for more.
Yeah, expectedly there is a slip in position because of that away swing that we are used to seeing from him. Is two fielders deep third and deep backward square. And a play and a miss. Ayub is very peculiar, Nikhil, in the sense that his strike rate in the power play is lower than his strike rate outside of the power play. And when you think of someone like Andre Fletcher, who is the opposite, strikes really high in the power play and slows down considerably thereafter, this guy is a special player. To score at the rate that he's been scoring outside the power play, phenomenal.
It's a good part of this, especially given the spin that they have, the Kings, but also these two seam options forward now, and it means that Joseph will bowl from that pavilion in, trying to make the most of the green grass a lot closer to us here from this end. Danny Morrison earlier had a look at it, so we'll look to extract that sideways movement.
Yeah, you're right. The pitch was a little bit unusual as well. One half of the pitch was, or is rather, well grassed, and the other is very much less grassed. So I'm thinking seam from one end and spin from the other as we go through this contest. Spinners will get a lot more purchase if they're bowling from this end, the end that Matthew Ford is currently operating from.
Was uppish. First runs off the bat for the Warriors. They've come out in their numbers second night in a row. The fans in Guyana, they do it differently. Making a big claim for the best in the region, must say. Remember, we'll have the final here as well. They'll be desperate to see their team, the Warriors, who were knocked out before that final in 2022.
Yeah, this young man will be high on confidence from that innings last night. Obviously, there will be a lot of nerves in game one, less so, but still around in game two.
Getting it to go away from the left-handers forward, both of them. Ground staff have done well. Wasim Habib and his team have used torgonal paints to get conditions ready for the action. We're on pitch 5 yesterday. Today we're on pitch number 3. Paint as well used for the stands around the stadium, which have been freshly painted and ready for this Republic Bank CPL 2023 edition. Good first over from Ford. 2 from it.
Yeah, it's loading. The first title. It's loading, or so they believe. Can this be their year? They've been saying it for the last decade or so, the Guyana Amazon Warriors and their fans. Can this season be the season where they break that duck?
Former West Indies cricketer Ramnuri Sarwan in attendance. Had some really good memories here. Roston Chase trying to create a few himself. And 2 left-handers in the middle. So Chase in straight away. And he's bowling from that end as well, because now it forces both lefties to hit into the much bigger side, 72 meters to the leg side for the left-handers compared to just 66. Down the track, that is gorgeous. Great way to get underway.
Yeah, Ian Bishop mentioned in the pre-show about Ayub's development of his play through the offside. This is a phenomenal shot first ball doesn't need a sighter down the track, inside out, hitting with the expected turn. So he puts the bowler under pressure immediately. Long off, deep mid-wicket, has two fielders out. What a riposte from Chase. Bounce and turn. He pulled his length back, and you can see the grip that he gets. Now that is interesting. No slip in position.
Quick single. It was a big component of that 100-run opening stand last night between these two.
Yeah, this should not have been a single. If you're in the inner circle and the ball comes relatively close to you, though the direct hit would have rendered him out, you don't want to be given easy singles off your good deliveries, and then your bad deliveries go for four. Then as a team, you're under pressure. Inner circle guys, particularly the first few balls of the over, cut a single. That's the rule of thumb.
This is familiar. Head over to the CPL chat app, scan the QR code on screen, engage with commentators and other fans, and collect unique emojis. Slip in place for that previous delivery and continuing against Nandu.
He has four fielders in a ring offside from extra cover to short third, because of the turn that he's getting and the bounce. So if Nandu wants to score, he has to score down the ground, which is a difficult shot to play. So this is a good bit of captaincy from Sikander Raza. Or does he fancy a sweep down leg side? It's risky.
Eight for none. Couple of changes for the Kings. Rajapaksa, left-hander, replacing another left-hander in Descartes. McKenny Clark in as well. Seam for spin, no carry pair tonight. I wonder how much that green grass would have influenced that decision. The fans are in as well. And they're looking forward to seeing their team remain unbeaten in this competition. Ford continuing.
Be interesting to see how much swing he gets in this over. Matthew Ford did get some in over number one. Sikander Raza would be enthused by what he saw from Ruston Chase in terms of the bounce and the turn. Has himself and Hatzoglu as options.
He's been very consistent on that line. Ford, on that fourth stump. And I wonder how much that breeze coming from the eastern side of the ground, pushing the ball across the left-hander, would have influenced the decision, because we thought pace ball from the other end where there's more green grass to bowl at. But Ford has opted to come from this media center end, angling it in and allowing the wind to do the rest.
He continues to bowl in that channel and continues to beat the bat. One from eight. Just have a look at this start from Matthew Nandu. We spoke a lot about the power and the depth of the Guyana Amazon Warriors. Puts a lot of pressure now on Sai Mayu, but I know it's only his second game, so he gets the latitude of a slow start, Matthew Nandu, but he has to learn on the job and learn quickly. let's have a little tease or insight. What have they got for us? Highest dot ball percentage in CPL 2023. Minimum 8 overs. Matthew Ford, look at that. 58% of his deliveries have been dots. Zari Joseph, not too far behind, along with Mohamed Amir. Only spinner in there, interestingly, Naki Lusain.
Couldn't quite get it. But you can see the intent is there. Coming back for two, have to hurry, really. Didn't expect that at all, but it shows the youth and exuberance in the middle.
Yeah, that should never have been two again. Nikhil, a little bit sloppy. Had the ball in his hand when they decided to come for two. The throw was wayward. Not even in the frame. Had it been anywhere close to the stumps, and that could have been problematic for the Guyana Amazon Warriors. In the end, all is well that ends well for them.
That one angling in. Good bowling this, 10 for none. It's a festival of cricket here in Guyana. Ross and Chase continuing.
Yeah, no slip for Ayub. Slip in for Nandu.
Direct hit. Looked very relaxed, Nandu. They'll take the second, but that could be a lot closer than they think in the middle.
Yeah, direct hits. You just never know with these direct hits. Again, if this is a single, the fielding team should be disappointed. Of course, if it's a run out, they'll be happy. Let's have a look. He's gone. Excellent fielding from Sean Williams, the direct hit. They don't know just yet out in the middle. Yeah, they're getting a cue now and they're celebrating. Not the way you want to be dismissed. Unfortunate for Matthew Nandu, but a great bit of fielding. This is what you need to do in the power play. Cannot afford to give any easy singles. Now Ruston Chase is signaling. Amazon Warriors, they lose their first. Nandu goes for three, 10 for one.
To the middle, Benny Goodnick, a couple of half centuries, unbeaten last night. Likes the Providence ground as well. Three of his CPL 50s have come here.
It changes the dynamic a little bit now with the right-left combination. So Ruston Chase has to change his angle, change his field, and perhaps even change his plan. Quite comfortable bowling to the two left-handers.
Yeah, they want to get a move on. As quick as Ayub has scored outside of the power play, they're only going at three runs and over.
Yeah, came quickly to the ball, but the direct hit is the difference. Guardian life happiness moment for the Kings.
I'm remember distinctly in St. Lucia when there was green grass on the pitch. That first game between the Tallowers and Kings, it was Chase and Green, two taller finger spinners who were getting purchase. Shea Hope will be hoping for success in his 50th game.
And they've been good generally in the field in the early exchanges. The St. Lucia Kings into the fourth over, only 10 runs on the board. And once reinforcement through the offside, Shea Hope is quite strong there. Doesn't mind a single if he tucks it leg side in mid-wicket. I don't mind this at all from the bowling team. Many bowlers do that as a defensive option. As we look at the Dream 11, most picked players so far, most selected, Sikandar Raza and Shea Hope at 91% apiece. Romario Shepherd, Charles, Alzari King, all featuring there. Log on and get your votes in.
Another excellent over from the Kings. Wicket and just one, 11 for one. Slow going so far for the Warriors, who won the toss, opted to bat first. Remember, they are qualified certainly in that top two, so they have two bites at the cherry in making the final. We want to maximize these 12 deliveries remaining in the Skyfair power play. Ford, when he's bowled well, they've been happy to continue with him for a third. Slight noise, wide signaled. Samuel, you were speaking about the difference in strike rates for Saim Ayoub. It's a real point of uniqueness, I should say, because when you look at the other openers who face at least 50 deliveries in the CPL, no one has had that drastic change where he struck at 190 outside of it. You can see most of them in the positive, Andre Fletcher below that positive mark, but it really is amazing how easy it is for him to score five fielders out.
Yeah, quite peculiar what he's able to do. Saim Ayoub, once he gets set, he takes on the middle phase. And that's something that we've seen more and more regularly with teams, the better teams in T20 cricket. They continue to increase the tempo throughout the course of the innings. In the early phase of T20 cricket, it was go hard in the power play and slow down through the middle. It's go hard in the power play and continue to go hard all the way through now. That's 19 dot deliveries and 26 deliveries. 19 balls that they haven't scored from so far. Forward against the left-handers, predominantly operates in that corridor outside off stump. Gets that swing as well as seam movement. 55% plays and misses.
He likes to use his feet. He loves to use his feet. Just the second boundary of this Skyfair power play, a creamy novelty sweep play.
And a good option. They've been sitting on their creases and they haven't been able to score. This time he decided to go down towards the ball, gets to the pitch of it and just lifts it over the infield. And he knows once he's able to do that, he'll get value for his shot. So a good option from Saim Ayoub. He's been having a blast of a season, his debut season in the CPL, and he's making it memorable.
Fortuitous, but he'll take it. Went straight this time forward. Ayoub equal to the task, leg buys though.
Yeah, that was due to the shot that he played previously. He advanced down the track and smashed him over cover. So he changed his line. He made the adjustment, Matthew Ford, but too straight. And as you can see there from the umpire's helmet cam, that's what you need to do as a batter. You need to put the bowlers under pressure so that they have to think about changing their lines and their lengths and even their fields, as he's doing now. He wants the fielder who was previously a deep third to come much squarer, so more in a deep point position. And the regulation backward point goes to short third. One shot from Saim Ayoub has caused this level of confusion.
Does well, does really well, Sean Williams. And smartly decides against the second. It's an interesting time of the game because given what we've seen about Ayoub and in the post-power play, some torogonal paints being used. They do everything, really. In the middle, in the stands, now on the face. But Samuel Faraza, in this CPL 2023, he needs this wicket of Ayoub. Remember, they need one win to qualify. Does he go Alzari next? It's a possibility, but Ford will want him now in this over with this delivery.
The Guyana Amazon Warriors off and running, but it's been a slow start for them. 23 for one after five overs here at the Guyana National Stadium. Look at it. We're in Providence, Guyana. It's match 26, and Alzari Joseph, Nikhil Utumjandani, predicted it. They need a wicket, don't they, Ian Bishop?
Yes, it would be nice if they could get one or two, and with Alzari Joseph, there's always that chance on this type of surface.
No. White ball to start. It's been an interesting start. Guyana Amazon Warriors won the toss, decided they were going to have a bat first. Perhaps a sign of a confident team. Team who wants to try a few things out before playoff time. St. Lucia, a very important match to win. They win here, they'll be qualifying for the playoffs. Oh, it's gorgeous. The sound off the bat alone. Four runs, Shea Hope into the action.
It is a typical Shea Hope shot. One of the shots that you think about when you think about the Barbadian and West Indian and Amazon Warriors batter. So Joseph now has to pull back his length and try to hit a good length or short of a good length into that grassed half of the surface.
Pick up a couple here. Now, there was an LBW shout last over. No one appealed. Let's have a quick look at it. Ian Bishop, who was given leg byes.
Hindsight and the technology. You don't always get them right as a fielding team, as a fielding captain, but that's one that got away.
Ooh, they'll rue that opportunity. This one redirected nicely, should be saved. Oh, McKenny Clark. He gave it a chance, but eventually the ball won the race. Very frustrated, but not this team, not these fans.
Good use of the pace initially by Shea Hope. Put the effort in McKenny Clark, but having gotten there, he'll feel he should have stopped it. But there's enough in the surface to reward who can bowl that good length as a seamer and a tight off stump line. There's enough in it for the spin as well.
Levin off the over so far. Oh, it's a couple of bubbles and an appeal.
Rajapaksa's having a shocker. It hit something because the umpire did not signal a wide, but Rajapaksa's been bubbling it. Hard to read Shea Hope's reaction there, but we've got technology that can tell us precisely.
Another quick run. We have seen a run out so far for the evening. Well, here's the appeal. Yep, no bat involved. So Rajapaksa off the hook.
Good umpiring, though. Very good from Reaper Jr. to sense that it hit something and that it wasn't bat. That would have been out as well. So they've missed three runouts tonight so far, the Kings in the field, obviously.
You would imagine Banika Rajapaksa's up and at him today after Sri Lanka's close win in the Asia Cup over Pakistan. Last ball thriller. He should be full of beans for the St. Lucia Kings tonight.
Yeah, Johnson Charles, who had done the job for some games before, he's in the outfield.
Twelve off the over, and that's the end of the Sky Fair power play. Six gone. The Guyana Amazon Warriors are 35 for one. The Guyana Amazon Warriors score in this Sky Fair power play. The key number there, 22 dots. This is their lowest power play score for the season. Lowest before this was a 39-1. Lots will be on the mind of the captain. Brings himself into the attack. Sikandar Raza, Zimbabwean.
Get a chance now to see how the ball reacts from what we would consider the drier end, the drier half outside the right-hander's off stump towards that player's pavilion end. To be fair, Austin Chase did get the ball to turn and bounce, bowling into the media center end. But it's not an easy surface, I don't think, to bat on initially against a hard ball. There's some movement, there's some spin, there's some bounce. It may settle down later, but for now, there's enough in it.
No! No! It's stout, and he knows it, Shea Hope. Raza's been very good for the Kings. came into the captaincy after the departure of Faf du Plessis. He's got 6 wickets in his 6 matches.
Almost sold himself too far down there, Shehope. Not pleased with Ayoub's call of no for the second. That's the bigger side of the ground, and Shehope felt there certainly was too.
And just here, the fans around this ground coming into full voice. Well, we've been having some wonderful shots of this gorgeous facility, this ground. Thanks to the Omega XL Skycam, here's takeoff. Gets up, and that's what we get to look at. Phenomenal. Roadblock in Providence. It is absolutely packed here, and it's going to get even more full as the evening progresses. So Matthew Nandu went cheaply, but this partnership 29 off 24 now for the Warriors. Five from it, 40 for one. Overs gone in this Guyana Amazon Warriors innings, 40 for one, and McKenny Clark into the attack. The youngster, St. Lucian. Really big stage, wonderful opportunity for this young talent. Ian Bishop, you know a bit about him.
Yeah, we talked about him and what Floyd Reefer espoused about his discovery by being sent a video of an under 19 colleague's dad of his. He both played that one game, bowled a limited, just bowled a couple of overs, I think. But he certainly looked then that he could get the ball through.
Yeah, he is one of the LASCO food drink emerging players in this competition. Lots of young talent in the Republic Bank CPL. You guys look out for them. You've seen Matthew Nandu already. Kelvin Pittman was outstanding in one of his matches. What a great stage and what a good initiative to develop the young talent of this region. It's an edge, but it will get all the way, go all the way. This is what happens when a player is in form like Shehope. Republic Bank boundary. Shrugged off by McKenny Clark.
Not a bad delivery at all from McKenny Clark. That's about the line you want to bowl. It's touchdown and off stump, and it's just left Shehope a touch. But the outfield is lightning. Yes, that solitary over in the previous game that Clark played.
It's quick. Ian Bishop, we saw Matthew Nandu get run out. Direct hit from Sean Williams earlier. What do you think about the rebuilding of this innings by Ayoub and Shehope?
Well, Ayoub is doing what he's done well in the last 3 or 4 games, in that he's come through the power play at about a run a ball and then accelerated. Now, it's a risky thing to do, because if you get nicked off, those deliveries don't come back. But he's obviously found a method that worked for him for three player of the match performances. Just crossed 300 runs in the tournament. The other thing now to add to your point or your question is Shea Hope. I want to know, and I should have said it last night, actually. It's unfair of me to say tonight. He scored three half centuries, but Shea Hope hasn't shown me anything with these three half centuries that I didn't know before. His strike rate is around 130. I have known that. What I want to see from Shea Hope is a more expansive, at times, effort to show us that muscle flexing that he showed us against India, that he's shown in the franchise leagues across the world in recent times. Because we know he can bat. We know he can score 50. We know he can cruise at a certain rate. Unless the team has given him this role, I still think with the depth they have, he can afford to maybe just go along, all things being equal, conditions apart. Let me be clear, conditions apart, a little bit quicker.
Higher strike rate. This is one of the key strategies for this shortest format of the game. T20 cricket, you've got to get moving. It's done well. McKennie Clark pulled it back after the boundary. Last ball. Roshan Primus giving it a go, but the ball wins that race, and it's 4 to end the over. 9 from it, 49 for 1.
We've seen it about three times now, that twice for Shea Hope and now for Ayub, that they're using the bowler's pace behind square on either side of the pitch to pick up boundaries. Tells you a little bit about the outfield and the pace.
Well, it's been a slow start. 122 the current score, but they'll be looking to go 8 or 10 and get close to 170. No doubt the Guyana Amazon Warriors. I tell you who will be expecting more runs on the board, and that's the fans gathered here today, the Providence Stadium. Lots of color in the stands and around the ground. These are the cheerleaders getting ready this evening. They're a big part of the live action on the night. Lots of cheering and partying like we do in the comm box. There they are, live in action. That was the BTS behind the scenes, and this is them in front of the big lights, the big stage, the big crowd here tonight for this match number 26 of the Republic Bank CPL. Raza continuing.
Yeah, I'm happy the Warriors saw this game as important enough to continue playing what they consider their best 11. It means that although they're guaranteed a top two spot for the playoffs, they still feel playing well, keeping your rhythm is important. There are additional benefits to that, but I think the other point I want to stress is that I understand Imran Tahir's decision tonight. It may or may not work out in a win, and this crowd wants to see a win. But he's thinking,
he's bowled him. Remove the furniture. Sikandar Raza leads this team and gives us an Eldorado celebration. Breakthrough for the Kings and the Danger Man. Ayub, it's got to go.
And you see, this is where the method of going slowly in the power play and looking to build outside the power play is playing Russian roulette. Sometimes it works, and it's worked three times for Ayub, but this time it does not work because he's 16 from 20 and 50 for 2 now for the Warriors.
Yeah. 50 for two, the Amazon Warriors. The two openers back in the hutch. Matthew Nandu and Saeem Ayoub. And Azam Khan comes out to join Shea Hope. Interesting match here. This guy can change a game as well. Hasn't had his best season. But a dangerous contender nonetheless. A different shape of game for the Guyana Amazon Warriors tonight, having lost the dangerous Ayoub.
Yeah, first time in three games that he hasn't gone on to get a half century. Good from Raza. Good from the Kings. Bowled straight. But I was about to finish that whole point for Imran Tahir. Since they've already qualified top two, guaranteed top two. He wants to put his team in a certain situation in that if they get to the playoffs and then they have to bowl second with the due, that they've had the chance to work on it. And that could or could not come at a cost in these preliminary games. But I think it's worth finding out.
Yeah, it's almost a privilege of a position where they find themselves now in the Republic Bank leaderboard, able to try different things, prepare for different eventualities. As we see Johnson Charles now behind the sticks.
Yeah, that's a good thing. Rajapaksa was struggling. He really was. He was just fumbling everything. And it's good that Charles has retained the gloves.
Big appeal again. Like it could have been a bit high.
Johnson Charles was indicating with the movement of his glove that it was going down the leg side. Just there, Johnson after that said down the leg side.
No! This is a very good over. Only two from it and the wicket. Nine gone. 51 for two.
It's not an easy surface. It's not a bad surface, but it's not an easy surface to bat on. And I think the same could be said of yesterday's pitch. And Ayoub said that to you at the end of the game. He said you had to be really precise and pick your bowlers.
The Guyana Amazon Warriors put themselves into bat, having won the toss here at Providence for this match 26. Gorgeous evening in Guyana. The fans are out, and which Azam Khan's coming out to play this evening?
It's a good point you make, Alex. Very good point indeed. And it's a good point because with Ayoub gone, and this is what Ayoub faced, just gripped a little bit in the surface. Azam Khan hasn't had a great tournament. You mentioned that. Averaging 12. Right? So I think you can't gloss over that. People have glossed over that. They've said everything is working for the Amazon Warriors. No, Imran Tahir was spot on last night. He said there are areas we still need to improve in. Azam Khan is one such area. They need to get him in form so that all the pieces can, if Ayoub doesn't score or Hope doesn't score, somebody else does. This is his season. He's a good player. But he's missing runs, and so that's a piece of the puzzle they're still hoping when he gets up that he can get some form.
All right, this is going to be our Angostura chill break. Have a drink, and we'll come right back. The openers went for a combined 19. Shea Hope and Azam Khan in the middle now. It's Guyana Amazon Warriors sit at 51 for 2. Some of the highlights so far. Well, Saeem Ayoub started as he's been going beautifully. And here's the run out. Direct hit from Sean Williams. Extraordinary. Sends Matthew Nandu back.
And then Hope and Ayoub put together a decent little partnership. A few fours down behind the wicket were special touches, and then Raza struck, removing Ayoub cheaply, a rarity this tournament.
So Sikandar Raza with the sole wicket, but everyone been pretty economical. Zari Joseph going for nines there, but he has been quick. 147 kilometers and 148 kilometers, his last two deliveries. Here's where we are. Gorgeous Guyana. Enjoying ourselves extraordinarily. And that's around by the seawall. And of course, the sponsor's product is the home of El Dorado. We love it, especially Danny. Great to be in this part of the world. It's the Caribbean country in South America. I'm interested to hear what you think, Ian Bishop, of Alzari's form. He's been quick this evening.
Yeah, yes, he has. And remember, just before that drinks break, he hit Azam in the shoulder. And I go back to Barbados. There was one game in Barbados, I remember saying it to you, that as I went to the pitch report and then went to rehearse for the pre-show, he was bowling in the warm-ups for about 20 minutes, 25 minutes. I thought it was longer. And I asked him why a couple of games ago, and he said his rhythm wasn't feeling right, and he just went out there and tried to bowl and bowl and bowl himself into his best rhythm, and once he found it in the warm-up, he stopped because he knew something had clicked, and suddenly his best rhythm. And I remember that game, he bowled like the wind in Barbados. Today so far he hasn't really hit that length that he prides himself on. He's still getting it through.
Yeah, the FedEx fastest deliveries today. Alzari Joseph, a couple of deliveries ago, got up to 148. McKenny Clark's pretty decent. Small sample size so far, to be fair.
Daylight between the top man and second place.
Yeah, that was just each bowler's fastest ball. But interesting, interesting what you say about Alzari Joseph. Muscle memory, huh? Sort of programming it into the body.
And into Shea Hope's body as well.
And Azam Khan's shoulder.
I think if I'm making a T20, if I'm doing a draft, I want an Alzari Joseph, and I want another. I may not get as much pace, but I want two of those types of bowlers in my squad. I know Shane Thomas and someone else. And Andre Russell and an Ali Khan, for example. I want two guys who could either bowl me the new ball, or one of them comes in the middle and one bowls a new ball and then comes back at the end. I want high pace in addition to leg spin, left arm spin in my squad, not necessarily the 11.
That's a big swing. It should drop into space, but what an effort, what a grab! He's not sure, Sean Williams. But if he's held on to this, that will be one take for the ages.
Yeah, good of him, I think, to indicate that he wasn't, as you said, 100% certain. So right for the umpires to check. We saw Fabian Allen take a screamer off of Kyron Pollard in Trinidad. They'll check the front foot, I think, which is the first thing.
Yeah, no problem with that front foot. It's a legal delivery. We spoke about Sean Williams in the pre-show. I mentioned to you he's such a dangerous player. Oh, it looks like he's put it down. Ooh, who knows? Fingers underneath, Ian Bishop?
This should give us a little bit of a better sighting. He's got some tape on his finger. Just remember that, some white tape. Nah, that's grounded. Yeah, and that's why I think he indicated straight away. Maybe not, I'm not sure.
Well, he was half an inch away from that catch. Oh, drop catch in the end, I guess you would call it.
Yep, but A for effort. I know some people who would have stood back and taken it literally on the bounce. But he committed himself and he went in. So I'm giving him a blind for this. Not an easy catch, inches above the ground.
I was getting ready to say fall into space. He was so far away from the ball initially, covered a lot of ground, he did. And this is what he offers his team. Value all over the cricket pitch.
But let us not get away from the fact that it was pace that caused Shehok to play that shot. Alzari bowled a couple of short ones at him and drew the loose shot at a delivery that was not there for the drive or the punch. Good pace.
Good pace and a great over from Alzari Joseph. Just three from it. And at the halfway mark, the Guyana Amazon Warriors are 54 for two.
Well, a bit of Peter Hatchigaloo. First time tonight. It's enjoying being in this part of the world. A nice little feature piece, having a chat to Nicole earlier. So let's see what he can make of this pitch. A pitch of two ends, certainly is. A bounce, no damage done. Rightio, time to carve it up in the fan stand with Naomi.
Danny, I am actually in the red stand, and honestly, what I think you just missed was the most silent crowd a while ago when we almost lost hope. But thankfully, all the flags went up as soon as we realized it was a not out. No, my warrior right here.
Yes.
He's been growling the whole match.
We're warriors. We're warriors. Win or lose, Warriors I choose. But of all the years before, this year we're bringing it home. Woo! This
okay.
Year.
Woo! All right, Kesha. Now, we didn't lose the last wicket, so you're feeling good, you're feeling confident. Send some words of encouragement to the Warriors if they could hear you.
I just said it, win or lose, Warriors I choose. But this year we're bringing it home.
So, what's so funny is Janae, right? Yeah. Janae and I have been here with the boys, having the best time laughing at them.
Yeah.
So you're all here tonight with your friends, but also, you know, this may not necessarily be your first crowd to be with. I think we're all happy that all the girls are sitting together now, right?
Yeah.
Can boys be a little bit silly with cricket sometimes?
For sure, yeah.
But the vibe in the stands, how would you describe it? Because, I mean, whether or not we're watching the game, we're just having fun, enjoying the vibe in Guyana, right?
Yeah, for sure. And honestly, I'm not really a sports person, so I don't understand what's happening out there. But the vibe alone in the stand is just so amazing.
Exactly. And the cool thing about CPL is that it's really about the loyalty to your country, right?
Yeah, for sure.
So last night, maybe we wouldn't have been friends in last night's match because I'm Jamaican.
Yeah.
But tonight, I'm a Warriors fan, right?
Yeah, so here we are now.
All right, so Kesha, what's your prediction? We're not fully all the way halfway through this innings.
There's no prediction. We are winning. We are winning this match. We are winning this tournament. There's no question.
All right. All right, Danny and Alex, take it.
You stay there in that red stand, Naomi. Fire up the crowd. And let's see if Azim Khan can get over that nice little bruise on his left pec and start caning it. One to go here in the 11th. Yeah. Good start from Hatzigalu. Only three from that over. It's 57 for two now. Half a dozen bowlers used here from the St. Lucia Kings. Raza, a bit of success. He's the only bowler in terms of analysis because the other ones are run out. But some good heat from Zari Joseph moments ago. Now it's McKinney Clark. One over. Going to lock horns here with Shea Hope. Bounce, slashed over extra. Didn't quite get all of it, but got enough of it, Sammy.
Yeah, much to their joy and amazement. On the top of the bounce, this was not a half volley. It was hit on the up by Shea Hope. He's very strong offside with this type of shot. Allows him to free his arms, McKinney Clark. Has three fielders deep on the leg side. Long one, deep mid-wicket, deep backward square. So perhaps a change of line. Yeah, makes the adjustment straight away. That's more or less the line that you want to bowl. Average first inning score here at Providence 2022 and what we've seen last night, 170. Drop slightly. A little bit, 170. Can they get there? The think tank for the Guyana Amazon Warriors. Download the Sports Max app and watch anywhere in the Caribbean, the CPL, all of its action. You can be part of the action as well.
He's only got a brace, a couple off seven deliveries, Azim Khan. That'll help. Let's split the two men. Yes, it has. A little bit of Caribbean flair there from Azim Khan to pick up his first boundary.
Yeah, we've seen a few balls fly and travel quickly across the ground. I just think that he has his fine leg a little bit too fine, McKinney Clark. That should have been in the region where the fine leg usually is. Johnson Charles making the adjustment now. Yeah, lots of dot balls, 40 dots. And we're only into the 12th over.
Retort from the bowler. Yeah, goes short. Smacks it in halfway down and yeah, he just loses a bit of shape there. I wonder if he's got a little bit rattled there from Alzari Joseph that hit him on the left peck. It was pretty tasty and flew on through and did cause him a bit of discomfort. And there he's just lost a bit of shape trying to slice it over point or a very square cover. That's not bad, is it? That's more like it, Azim Khan. And they're rejoicing in the stands here. Get stuck in, ladies. It's happening here at Providence.
Yeah, not too dissimilar from the shot that Shea Hope played earlier in the over. Again, the line is the issue. You don't want him to be scoring there or with your mid-off in position. Again, the ability to free his arms. And Azam Khan doesn't miss out. So two fours with two badly lined deliveries. He's made an adjustment in his feet, long off now in play. He's brought the fine leg in the inner circle.
Fresh air to finish. We've had a dozen, and it's 70 for two now.
The Amazon Warriors is 70 for two.
Yeah, that is classy. Now, maybe Shay Hope in particular and Azam Khan heard Ian Bishop. Just wanted to see a bit more dynamicism from Shay Hope in particular. But certainly now, with their revving up the cheerleaders and the fans here at Providence, can they get a wriggle on these two? Sammy, I've got my music gear back. The Omega XL vitamins. I tell you what, these are some of the most potent fatty acids in the world going around for a vitamin. Of course, you know why? Green lip muscles is part of the development. Inside these. Get into them, please. I am. I need them. Straight and clean. Not quite all of it. Hope is sort of stuck in second gear. He's 33 from 31, just striking it over a runner ball. But yeah, it needs to start to find that range. Hatzigaloo, tricky, tall, and all his idiosyncrasies as he sets himself up to get ready to fizz on in. Wrist spinner from South Aussie. Oh, that is dynamic. And that is almost a great piece of fielding, but not quite. Ball wins.
Yeah, just opens himself up, Azam Khan, that left leg out of the way so that he can have a full bat swing. Yeah, he made that movement quite early so that he can access extra cover. Again, the dew on the surface means that the ball slides across it quite quickly. Fielder had no chance. Azam Khan against leg spin strikes at 168, folks. He likes this type of bowling. Hatzigaloo is a quick leg spinner, likes the ball into the surface, quite tight line, bustling type action. Yeah, and that's generally his modus operandi. Back of a length and into the pads for the right-handers. Rarely does he stray outside off stump. Doesn't get much turn because of the pace at which he bowls. Slidey type leggy.
With the wide, seven off, half the over gone. Bowler under pressure. Just lost his run up there. Got a focus, and now he's not happy with the ball. So he's handed it over to Mr. Butler, who says, carry on, Pete. Give it a rip, champ. Let's see what you got. Up against Shay Hope. Let's see what Hope's got here. Oh, it's another terrific looking stroke. No, oh, you've got to stop those when you get there. McKenny Clark left sprawling.
Yeah, it was traveling. It was hit with some ferocity from Shay Hope, but not for the first time tonight. We've seen that McKenny Clark did all of the hard work, but couldn't do the finishing touches. Yes, he got an awkward bounce at the very end, but you still need to get something behind it. There's been a change in field now. He's been dispatched to the inner circle. The captain himself goes to that long off position.
Yep, sent to Coventry. Young McKenny. Oh, it's lost his footing there, did he? Shay Hope.
Yeah, have a look at where that fielder is at fine leg. He's almost directly behind the wicketkeeper. Quickly through him. This is how he generally operates. But the fine leg is very, very fine. Not often do you see him that fine. Look at that.
Yeah, part of the ploy and almost had his wicket there. Hatch glue. He's going to keep the strike here. So 12 off the 13th and the Warriors are 82 for 2. Finally, a couple of tall buildings for the fans to get excited about here at Providence. Well, some El Dorado celebrations of the season. Oh, talk about airtime. 40, you little ripper. And then the DJ on the dance floor, he's got the shoes to burn. And Hetmeyer having a crack at the Spice Man and Dominic Drake's. It's some version of the Harker, that one. And then Junior Sinclair, because we can, he says, with the flip. So now we've got Matthew Ford, the one with the Air Jordans on. Not Alex, Michael, with a bit of air time, with the celebrations. And started off, as he does with a new ball, and gets it to curve beautifully in the air. And so Raza thinks, yep, the 14th, let's finish you off here, Matthew Ford. Get you done. 12 dots to go with the 12 runs. Very good indeed. Here he comes in his characteristic hooping, hopping run. Oh, you're kidding! In the follow-through. Pop this one in the El Dorado locker. That is a beauty. He knew nothing about it in a way. It was a reflex. Couldn't get out the way. Hooray!
Self-preservation more than anything else from Matthew Ford. Struck back directly at him. Did well. Alligator style and all from Matthew Ford. Celebration El Dorado style. Gets the breakthrough for the Kings. Shea Hope goes for 38 from 35. 82 for 3.
Time for the Hetmeister. He's pumped and shimmering. Hetmeister's ready to rock and roll. Might not have had his biggest, bestest season going around. He's had a couple of good hands, a couple of cameos, certainly against Trumbago Knight Riders. The end of Shea Hope with a wonderful little reflex caught and bowled by Matthew Ford, saying, please don't hit me. I might as well catch it. And another one for the vault locker. So the left-handed Hetmeyer. Ford in his last, his fourth over. Gets the breakthrough. Yeah, they want it more. You sense it and feel it. I ran into Darren Sammy and co prior to the pitch report. Now you can see they really are desperate, those in blue, to get a win here. He's underway as Hetmeyer, but it was a little aerial. Yeah, it's simple as this. Win this, and they're into the qualification, a cue against their name. The St. Lucia Kings, that's what they're looking for. Win this tonight, get it done and dusted, and make sure you're in the playoffs.
Yeah, two cues there, Danny. We're looking for four. Kings, Royals, and Talawas fighting, jostling for two spots. Who will it be? The defending champions, remember, the Jamaica Talawas still in with a chance.
Quite cute, you were thinking that Royal Flush then, weren't you? With all those cues, all the queens. Yeah. Rightio. What's Ford got? Oh, he's gone short into that body again. Quick man. Yeah, he likes to play the pull or swivel the hook. Does Azim Khan. I do like that. And I tell you what, the bowlers like that too, because it's a big target to hit. And that's what the quick men will be liking and thinking. Certainly Alzari Joseph was.
Angostura chill, refreshing moment of the match. Look alike, a doppelganger, Danny Morrison.
Yeah, ran into this fellow and he said, I'm getting all this kudos from around the grounds, Danny. Going, Danny, get up here, share a drink with us. They think it's me. Standing.
He's much better looking, isn't he? Down the ground, chase one. Zari Joseph. Yeah, I don't think he did what was needed to be done. A valiant effort, but a boundary before Chevron at my his first.
Yeah, lovely bit of timing, wasn't it? Almost a bit, but a super save from Joseph. Did all the hard work there, but the ball got tangled up inside him. And then his momentum just couldn't quite haul it back whilst he was touching the boundary cushion. Yeah, that Danny double, he's on the front of GQ and a catwalk model. Very, very sexy, that fellow. I'm glad to be in the same league. No run there, says Hetmeyer.
Yeah, a bit of a start coming through from Matthew Ford. This season is the first time that he's bowled in the middle phase. He generally operates in the first six. Bowled one over at the back end of the innings. You've got to be so pliable as a player in T20 cricket. Flexibility is the key. Can operate at any phase, whether you're a bowler or you can come at any stage if you're a batter. Straight to the fielder. Well timed, no run. 88 for 3 after 14.
Tough going, tricky surface, not the worst, but it is challenging, particularly with a new ball, and there is that bit of bounce for the spinners when they bowl from this broadcasting end towards the players' pavilion. That shaven end, a little bit of turn, a little bit of bounce. It's that bingo score, two big ladies for three, the Warriors, and a very good spell comes to end from Matthew Ford. One for 18. Oh, 3 minutes behind. Naughty, but there was a bit of stoppage in play for fitness. A couple of little injury blows to Azim Khan and Shea Hope. Had a bit of running repairs and the physio out there, so that may go in the Warriors' favour.
Let's have a look at what the Warriors have done so far in this innings. 16 from 20, 3 from 11, 38 from 35. Those are the batters dismissed, only one above 100. So it's been somewhat of a struggle. Can these two and the others to come finish off with a flurry? Warriors will be hoping that. Colin Munro seems to be the guilty party there. Allows them at least a couple, yeah. Picked up two. Chevron Atmeyer, the second leading run scorer in the CPL. at this venue behind Lindell Simmons coming into this innings. Familiar, of course, with these conditions, heels from these parts. And they'll be looking towards him for the remaining matches. So many hopes rest on his shoulders along with the rest of this Guyana Amazon Warriors team. Could this year be their year, Danny? Look into your crystal ball.
Well, I'm a bit worried about you putting the mockers on them again. What are you doing? It's your fault. I'll tell you everyone now. I can hear that right here live on commentary. Sammy B's put the mockers on the Warriors again. Yeah, well, look, 5 finals out of 10. Extraordinary record. Someone's got to be a bridesmaid, though. Oh, dear, that's well taken and well stopped, rather, from Johnson Charles. Fired him down the leg side. That should be a double wide, Sammy.
Yeah, very well taken. Rajapaksa had the gloves initially. Got a bit of a finger injury, so Johnson Charles, that was fired in, for sure. One of the things that the teams playing here and those looking on will want to factor in is getting their spinners out of the way quite early. Because of the dew factor and how wet that ball gets, especially if you're bowling second, you want to get the spin overs out of the way perhaps in the first 12 to 14 overs so that the faster men operate at the back end. It gets quite wet. Well, it got quite wet last night. Here remains to be seen if that continues tonight.
Just a little bit of rotation here. Not too many boundaries. Still hasn't been a Republic Bank maximum in this innings. Extraordinary.
Yeah, so he has options there. Chase has 2. McKenny Clark has 2. Hadzoglu has 2. So remains to be seen along with Joseph who will bowl these remaining overs. And does he utilize his spinners at the back end?
Lovely and straight, is it? Clark with the soccer skills. Brilliant. Bet Barter super save, you betcha. Saved another boundary there. 7 off the 15th, and the Warriors are 95 for 3. The hands weren't working, so he went with the feet. Oh, yes. Sign him up for Man City. Brilliant.
Slowish middle phase for this Warriors side. But again, conditions haven't been the easiest to bat on. Just speaking to some of the players last night, they felt surface got a touch better as the dew came in, and it did come in. 1 minute behind the timer. 17th over, they could pay the price. Hadzoglu, the leg spinner continuing. Hello to Ian Bishop.
Hello, Nikhil. Hello, everyone. Yeah, it's a tough surface at the moment, but a chance for Hetmyer and Azam Khan to impose themselves in these last 5. Game in the balance. Chance for the Kings as well to see if they can restrict them to under 150, 160.
Just judging by the reaction of Hadzoglu, I think they may have been bad on it. Primus as well, Charles, all of them seemed quite disappointed, but always tough. Reaction time, not much. There was a big edge. Hetmyer is a man you probably want dismissed before he gets set and gets going. Hadzoglu has only taken 3 wickets this season. New role for him as well, bowling in this phase. disastrous. Finally, a Republic Bank maximum for the Warriors.
And the Amazon Warriors need a few more, a couple more before the end of the innings. Good to see Azam Khan striking the ball at times very well. They need him to get back to his best form. Look to be aggressive and bat with intent, because you've got that engine room which includes the two batters at the crease and of course the other guys to come, the Shepherds, the Pauls, the Pretorius, who've been so good all season. Even at the cost of a wicket or two, you have to show intent. Wow, absolutely impressive from Azam Khan, two in the over now, a Republic Bank maximum. Wonderful ball striking, terrific ball striking. Hatzoglou's trying to keep the length away from him from hitting down the ground. He says, no, the length isn't there, I'll sweep. Wonderful power hitting.
Now going to his highest score of the season. Remember, he was 17 from 17. Gave himself the platform. 16 from his last two deliveries. Does he have one more in him?
And does Joseph come back? Joseph has two critical overs up his sleeve.
One 13 for three.
Matthew Ford, very good for him, 1 for 18 from his 4, and a key wicket, that of Shea Hope. Zari Joseph, as I said, has a couple up his sleeve.
Will be time for Zari Joseph. This last over, Azam Khan was powerful.
Yeah, struck down the ground once, tried to repeat it, got the edge, and then decided if the length is going to be there, then I'm going to go across the line if I can't reach it. So that's an over they badly needed, the Amazon Warriors, and they need a couple more. Go to rario.com and buy your official CPL player cards. Is Azam Khan on that tonight, his highest score of the season, or will it be Zari Joseph as one of your favorites who's now back into the attack? Bigger side of the ground is leg side. Right, so he could use the hard length into the pitch, use the short ball if he wants, or his yorker if he chooses to, with three deep fielders, Lexa.
Azam, wow. The switch has been flicked.
And it was a short ball from Zari Joseph, but that was hit flat. He was coming at it as a... And to be able to come at it and still play the horizontal bat shot, I think tells you that he is set. At Zari Joseph's pace, that's not easy to do. And that's the big side of the ground. Nelly took out one of the extras.
Thank you. Bish, I see that shot there. As I'm taking on the big side and with the wind, as a fast bowler, does Joseph consider the smaller side because Azam will have to hit into the wind, which is his offside, or is he happy to back himself for the bigger side, which is the leg side?
Yeah, I think at 72 meters, I think, even though there's wind, but I don't think the wind is significantly strong. I think occasionally he'll test him with that short ball, even with the short fine leg. I know some bowlers who would have said, no, the hitting with the wind, it will be too easy, so I'll prefer the short side into the wind, but it's six of one, half dozen of the other. That's the first and last short ball for the over, so he has to change his length now or be very accurate if he gets it up to about chest high.
It's gone straight up. And Clark takes it comfortably. That is real maturity and a big wicket. Khan goes and look at the stare.
Reminded me of Marlon Samuel saluting Ben Stokes a few years ago when he didn't say a word, just pointed the way to the pavilion. But that's a change of length. He had already used his one short ball for the over, so he went hard length. And given that McKenny Clark hasn't had a great night in the field along the ground, that's a real confidence booster. Deadly silence and a stare from Alzari. Good touch though from Azam Khan, 40 from 25, 119 for four.
From Essequibo, Kimo Paul.
No love lost there. I think once you cross the boundary, Alzari is all business. And that's just what you call a heavy length, where you're not floating it on a length to define it. More specifically, you're banging the ball into a good length, not floating it up there, so it hits a splice of the bat. Hetty is always ready to have fun in the most tense situations. Our producer, who's never short, three under 19 World Cup winners there, 119 for four. Well, the context of this is that the Kings desperately need to win. They need one more win from their last two games to qualify for the playoffs. So they are all business, not that the Amazon Warriors are taking their foot off the gas. But they are sitting comfortably.
Azam Khan, the standout. Now, where does Raza go? Animated discussions with Lezarifa Jr. and they're a minute behind. You've seen this look a lot from captains in this tournament. No one wants to bowl with just 4 feeders outside the circle. And courageously, he's going back to Hatsoglu, who went for 18 in his last over. Remember, if you stay behind in this over, then you lose a second fielder in the next one. Then, of course, you can get that dreaded red card in the final over where a player has to leave the field. They had options. Raza has one. McKennie Clark has only bowled two.
Yeah, McKennie is a bit of a risk, isn't he? Young and into his only second game of CPL. So that's risk-reward.
Could have gone chase as well. Left-hander in Hetmeyer, and he's back chase before to bowl the final over a couple of games ago in that game against TKR, actually.
Why is Roshan Primus not given more bowling in this squad?
Oh, well, that's well, really. Overran it. But the timing from Kimo Paul underway.
And I like everything I see about this young man, Matthew Ford. I think he needs to develop a leg cutter or one that straightens to supplement his in-swinger to the right-hander. But he's very energetic in the field, full of energy and commitment. I like him with bat, with ball, or in the field. Young player, but will develop or could develop handsomely for this type of format of the game.
Cover comes into the circle. Hatsuglu has to be straight. Just long off back on the offside. Win a trip to attend the Republic Bank CPL final. Post a fan of the Caribbean Airlines' social media. Just use the hashtag Cal to CPL and you could win.
Posting a picture of my wife and daughter. I want them to come for the final. Hope we win it.
Shimron, the home fans love that and he loves this home.
A Republic Bank maximum if ever there was one. And they need a few more to end this innings. They want to get beyond that 150 mark. Too easy for Shemron Hetmeyer into the pitch.
Yeah, second best team in this phase, the Warriors. They got close to 12 and over. They need 150. 11 and over gets them there.
Yeah, that's... I'm not saying that the way that Amazon Warriors play the game is wrong with that wide. I just think there's so much firepower. There's no need for any of the top-order batters to go along at a runner ball or just over and leave resources inside. I think they could kick off even earlier rather than waiting for the last five because they've got such depth. Even if you get rolled over a couple of times in the season, it's worth it. But use your resources more effectively.
Hasn't quite worked. 16 from the over, 135 for four.
Yeah, four byes to end that over. Warrior Nation, listen, I cannot tell you how expectant they are about a championship. The way that they're talking on the streets, they're wearing the Amazon Warriors t-shirt everywhere.
That over of spin has helped the Kings get back on target. So Raza's been very intriguing in terms of the decisions he's made. To bowl the penultimate, he's gone to young McKennie Clark. Pressure on. The first two overs were expensive. Can he rein things back? Last three overs, they've got 40 runs. he's got Shimron Hetmeyer at the other end. Wow. Kimo Paul took off immediately.
That is in keeping with how Kimo has played the game this year. Full of energy, full of enthusiasm. I think he's gone up an extra level. That's very smart. Whatever the outcome, if you get bat and ball or not, we are running. And because it was pace off, he sensed it straight away. It's bouncing to Johnson Charles, so we had a chance for one. Well home. Is he going into the pitch at Kimo, or will he serve up the odd attempted Yorker with a big side, leg side, and three deep boundary fielder?
This is why you want to strike. Taking full advantage.
I think it was an attempted Yorker, even though he may have held it cross seam because it's a little bit maybe slippery out there. Very smart from Kimo Paul to know where the gaps are and not overhit it or try to overhit it.
And look, it's a tough time for Clark to bowl in, but Matthew Ford talked religiously about being put in these situations for a couple seasons in 21 and 22, helping him to become a much better bowler. So, Bish, I hope you would agree that regardless of how this over goes, McKenny Clark will be a more improved bowler just after these four deliveries because of the experience and bowling at this phase.
Oh, yeah, I'm all for the young guys. These guys are, to me, these guys are my heroes. I look beyond the faults and see the needs. I look at what they can be instead of what they are now.
Oh my word. That is up the stadium or no, Justin. Kimo Paul is not messing around though.
But in the context of the game, what it is, I refer to what I said to you two overs ago when you asked me, it's risk-reward because he doesn't have a great deal of experience. So in a game like this where you're desperate to win, it is taking a risk. I was wondering whether they could go full and wide at Kimo Paul with a deep backward point, even though it's a short side. You have to love what Kimo Paul is bringing this season, though, Nikhil. You have to love it.
That is disdainful. Another maximum. 18 already off the over.
I think that's going into the gold account and getting a gold card for Republic Bank maximum. This is carnage of the highest order, exactly what they needed, the Amazon Warriors. This is their engine room that is buzzing and purring.
To your point, Bish, if they can do this at this time, why not start earlier?
100% agree, and I know people looking at me and saying, what are you saying, Bish, Mr. Bishop, Klong, whatever you want to call me. But there's too much depth in Amazon Warriors batting. They've had a great season, but I'm looking at, can they be better? Shepherd striking at 250 this season. 250 plus.
Two is the call. Get it comfortably. End of the over. One to go. 156 for four.
Pretorius is another one. Although he hasn't fired consistently, he can smack the ball. So I'm always looking at how can we be better as a team or as an individual. And I think that's another gear shift this Warriors team, dominant Warriors team, can go to.
Oh, Amazon Warriors, they make it look easy in this phase of the innings. Last four overs, they've gone out of 15 and over. So it's up to Alzari, Joseph, Raza, and this King side to restrict them. I'll tell you, anything is possible. They get 20 from here, all of a sudden. Remember, they were only 35 for one after the Skyfair power play. Hetmeyer's at the other end. He strikes at 170 against Joseph, but Kimo Paul will face first. Deep third, backward square, mid wicket, and long on. Sorry, joining deep cover as well.
Yeah, 21 off the over, so I guess to your point, he'll be better for it, he'll learn, but it's a tough situation to put him into in his second game of his CPL career against this type of hitting power. So I'm being diplomatic in saying he shouldn't have bowled it.
Mid-off still up. Is Joseph brave enough to go Yorker or brave enough to go into the pitch and force Paul to take on that short side?
Run up and look at his feet in your peripheral. Look at his feet to see whether he's staying in or tailing out.
This should be out. And Clark takes another superb catch.
Again, it's bowled. Joseph caught McKenny Clark. And again, it's a silent treatment from Alzari Joseph. Not exuberant in his celebration. His former under-19 World Cup winning teammate. But you're looking at Kimo Paul's feet. The ball before he tailed away, outside leg stump. This time he stood still and Joseph tied the ball into his feet. Paul goes for 19, 1-5, 6-5.
Shepherd, 240 this season.
Yeah, kept it close to him. You could see Alzari pushing it into his feet, saying, I'm not giving you time to use your arms. That's a good catch by McKenny Clark. Going over his right shoulder. He calls for it, says mines. Good awareness. He'll be a good cricketer in time to come, that young kid.
Yes. Oh, Shepherd. The way he strikes a cricket ball, almost unmatched in this CPL.
I would go further. The way he strikes a cricket ball, he needs to face more deliveries. It almost seems a crime that Shepherd is facing three deliveries or four deliveries at the back end of an innings. Now, he may be dismissed off this one, but he's such a difficult customer who I think he could be used in different positions.
Even after that shot, mid-off still stays up. Went Yorker, but Shepherd again able to get under it and hit it straight. And look at the little Shepherd, Junior Shepherd, celebrating.
He gives his dad a hard time when dad doesn't do well. But dad is having a great season. Outstanding with bat in his limited role, outstanding with ball, and really is settling into every level of the game.
Two down the ground, two boundaries that is, but mid-off stays up. Final delivery. This time goes short and they'll take and sneak the extra run. It is a mammoth final five overs to this innings. They've got 72 off the last five and have salvaged 167. That could be competitive.
there's some serious competitive energy between Alzari and several guys, and it's all in good fun. Shepard was complaining and wondering whether that was the second one over shoulder height for the over. Alzari said, "No, make your way off." It's 167 to work with, the chastening night for McKenny Clark, but he'll improve. He'll get better with experience. Matthew Ford, I thought, was outstanding. And Alzari Joseph once again leading from the front with 2 for 31. A game that the Kings, more than the Warriors, want desperately to win.
Yeah, they'll be thinking about a lot, the Warriors. Only got 60 in the middle and only lost 2 wickets. Could they be a bit more expressive? Azam Khan was excellent. 17 from his first 17. Then accelerated nicely as the innings progressed. But that engine room, as Ian Bishop quite often describes it, haven't seen Pretorius, haven't seen Smith. They still get 167.
If you're asking, you want to ask me if they could be more aggressive in the middle? Yes. Partnerships there, 40 from 34 between Ayub and Hope. That could be quicker. 32 from 30 between Azam and Hope. That could be quicker. Hetmeyer and Azam lifted it a bit. But great credit to Ford. Great credit to Joseph. Raza, 1 for 14, was very good. So all in all, still game on. Down to Alex Jordan.
Yeah, I'm with Matthew Ford. 1 for 18, tidy spell. What did you observe out there?
For me, usually Guyana's a quite up and down wicket. So for me, it was just about getting the ball in good areas and keeping it as simple as possible.
Well, you were very economical and you got the all-important wicket of Shea Hope. Talk me through that.
The captain called on me upon where he needed a breakthrough, and for me, luckily I could have done that from my side, so it's a plus.
All right, you have missed a few games this season. You were out with a side strain. How did you cope emotionally? What were you doing when in your timeout?
That was the hardest time of my life in terms of with the management staff and Dr. Bayam. That's the hardest I ever worked in the gym, so I don't ever want to be injured again. Obviously, we have injuries in the game, and it's frustrating, so for me, it's just about keeping fit and being on the park.
When you talked about the hardest time, you know, hardest working physically, but emotionally, how did you cope?
It was frustrating, but the good thing about it is that my side was, we were winning games, so for me, it was just about cheering on the guys on the sideline and doing as much as I can to get back out there as soon as possible.
All right, let's talk about winning games. 35 runs in the power play, but 72 in the death. Have you guys done enough? 167, what do you think?
I think Guyana picked up a bit of momentum here, but for me and the guys, we've been batting well all season, and I'm definitely backing my guys to get the total.
In terms of the service, what would you tell your batters?
It's a little tricky surface, but I guess once you apply yourself, you bat long enough. You know, runs as we saw from Azam Khan and Shea close to the end of his innings, runs came easier as they batted.
Good spell tonight. Well bowled.
Thanks, Alex.
Getting set, says Matthew Ford, is the key to success. We'll see. On the other side of this break, it'll be 168 for his Kings to get. Don't go anywhere. flame. Azam Khan started slowly, was cautious, but 23 runs from his last 8 deliveries played a big part in kick-starting things for that Warrior batting lineup, who are not short of any power, as we've seen time and time again. But Alzari, he fought back, Ian Bishop. They'll look to that middle, I think, going forward, and maybe think about improvement. But again, Hetmyer, Paul Shepherd, the impetus needed in the last 5, 72 from the last 5 to get them close to 170, could be a challenging total. Bish, the wickets, what did you see?
Yeah, the run out, it had to come. He was missed, Nando, twice before he was run out, and then a slow start again for Ayub, ended by Raza's guile. This was good from Matthew Ford. Good catch again. I think Shehub is going too slow. He could be better. He has the skill. And then Alzari struck back hard into the pitch, and a good catch by McKenny Clark. And that wasn't the end of McKenny Clark's catching, because he was in business again for Alzari to get rid of Kimo Paul.
Alzari again, 2 wickets for him. Interesting that Raza didn't opt to go back to himself or Roston Chase. Both 2 economical overs inside of the power play. Went to pace and went the distance. Hatsoglu traveled as well. Azam Khan leading the way in terms of the Dream 11 most fantasy points. Good for him to get a return to the runs. Highest score of the season so far. Alzari again. Sikandar Raza could play a part with bat in hand. That's a lot of points for you, Dream 11 users. It's been fascinating, and it can only get better from here. The other 20 overs coming up very soon. Don't move a muscle. Welcome back to Providence, Guyana. We have match 26. The Amazon Warriors still unbeaten in this Republic Bank CPL. The Kings in hunt of their win to put them in the playoffs. Well, so many beautiful sights and wonders of the world here in Guyana. One is Kaitcher Falls, the world's largest single drop waterfall, 226 meters, 741 feet in height, and 4.5 times the height of the Niagara Falls. You need to see it, Samuel Badri.
Yeah, I saw it last time I was here for the CPL, had the opportunity to visit, and it's really a humbling experience to see this majestic beauty and just to hear the pounding and the thunderous sound of the water falling. The flight across there was also something to experience. So if ever you get the opportunity to come across here, you must visit the largest, as you mentioned, single drop waterfall in the world. A wonder of the world, truly. And speaking about wonders, one wonders whether or not the St. Lucia Kings can chase this total down. Remember, a win for them will secure a top four finish. Johnson Charles, as we have seen before, at the top of the order for the Kings, hasn't had the best of seasons, along with Colin Monroe. Colin Monroe is coming off a good century, half century rather, against the Trinbago Knight Riders at the Brian Lara Cricket Academy. And these two are very experienced at the top of the order. Drake Pretorius has been good. 4 of his 10 wickets coming in the power play. An economy of 5.5 in this phase of the innings. Look for his outswinger slip in position.
Charles is underway. Oh, had to hurry there in the end. Visit the Skyfair website for the best betting odds. Go to skyfair.vip. Intriguing for the viewers at home to monitor this, because this Kings opening partnership, first Faf and Charles, now Monroe and Charles, have been the best in the tournament. Just over 50. Oh, look at the timing. That looks so easy on the eye.
Yeah, first boundary for Monroe, first boundary for the Kings. He just touched that ball, tapped it in the offside, tapped it in the gap, and it raced away. Exceptional and exquisite timing from Colin Monroe. And just a little bit of an advancement towards the ball and opens the face of the bat on contact. Good response from Pretorius. Yeah, Imran Tahir mentioned last night, Nikhil, that he wanted to challenge his bowlers if given the opportunity. That was a challenging ball for the batter. Bowling second, he won the toss tonight and did exactly that. The spinners later on will have an opportunity to bowl with the wet ball in preparation for tougher games to come. They did well with the back towards the back end of the inning. 72 for 2 in the last 5 is what they scored. Struggled, I would say, in the first 15. All of these experiences here will stand them in good stead as they go towards the knockout stages of this competition.
We saw 6 overs of seam in the Skyfair power play last night for Tahir. But of course, that time they were bowling first. Is he brave enough to maybe go for an over of spin? Maybe even himself. He's gotten both these openers out a combined 9 times. Four dots there in the over, 5 for none.
Yeah, the Guyana Amazon Warriors got close to what is par here in the last two seasons, 170 average first inning score, or rather not the par score, 170. There or thereabouts, 167.
Asking rate is just around 8.5. They want to stay on top of that. The Kings, Shamar Shepherd bowled just two overs last night in the Skyfair power play. Were concerns and questions about his fitness. Just management though. Back today, good to see him running in. Oh, that looks a good shot. Finger goes up straight away. And Shepherd strikes, no inclination to review from Charles.
El Dorado celebrations from Romario Shepherd and his teammates. The very first delivery of his spell, trapping Johnson Charles on the crease. Neither back nor forward. Bang on target. What a start. That's exactly what you want as a bowler. Challenge the stumps in these overs. Charles fails, falls for one, 5 for 1.
Banuka Rajapaksa back in the team, back in at number 3. He'll be happy man as well. His nation, Sri Lanka, picked up that win earlier today.
A good decision from the umpire. Also a good decision from Johnson Charles not to review. He knew. Not often you see a batter walk when he's struck on the pad. Johnson Charles almost walked before the umpire raised his hand. On that occasion, it is the most wickets in the power play this season. Romario Shepherd, 8 of them. Nazari Joseph also featuring here tonight, as well as Ruston Chase in the top 5.
I don't know the reason why Charles has found it so difficult here at Providence. 12 innings, he's only averaged 11 and struck at 100. Monroe as well, who's at the other end, he's batted here 8 times, this being his 9th. Struck at less than 100, so Shepherd will have that at the back of his mind. Saw a few deliveries go past the outside edge against Pretorius in that last over.
Has been in and out of the team. Rajapaksa says always difficult for a player to come straight in and get going after sitting out for a few games. Junior Sinclair, he's on the field in that extra cover region, substitute on for the opening batter Saim Ayub. We understand has a little bit of a niggle with his groin. It's challenging for the Amazon Warriors players.
Was a slip, and it was a very capable slip fielder in Shea Hope, but can't get to it. First runs and boundary for Rajapaksa.
Yeah, neatly guided. I'm not entirely sure he wanted to guide it that fine, but it was quite deliberate in the direction that he wanted it. Comfortably away from Shea Hope. So he's gotten going. Monroe has gotten going, both with boundaries.
Look at the wrists. Such quick hands, Rajapaksa. Great way to end the second, 13 for one.
Three. Yeah, clipped away by Rajapaksa again. Movement down the track. So this seems to be a plan from the batters to get closer to the ball. But very risky from the Sri Lankan.
Kings down one early, but so much batting depth, similar to the Warriors. Pretorius continues. Let's go down to Naomi Cowan.
We are in the Republic Bank fan stand, and as you can see, the Warriors fans behind me are all beautiful father-daughter situation with me here, Shiloh and Malia. Tonight, you brought your daughter out for this wonderful match. How do you feel the Warriors will perform?
Oh, the Warriors are doing good. I'm happy that they're performing well this year. The only reservation we have is that a few years ago, they took us to the finals and then disappointed us. And that was a really, real, real heartbreak. I hope that this year we don't have the same experience. I love the way they're playing right now. And we are going to be behind them all the way.
Absolutely, because, you know, at the last few overs, they just came right through.
Yeah, I was expecting that. You know, there was something that had to give in the last few overs, and I'm happy that Hetty Maya and our local boys, Kimo Paul and Romario Shepard, brought it close to us. We were hoping for a 140, but we got more than 140. We're happy. This is defendable.
Nice. So how we feel about more than 140?
We had a guy in his special. Well done.
Awesome, awesome. Now, I'm actually standing with the very, very first Miss Cricket Carnival. So in 2022, in recognition of the CPL Finals being here in Guyana, they hosted the Cricket Carnival Festival, and she was crowned Miss Cricket Carnival 2022. Amel Griffith, how are you doing tonight?
I'm super excited, Naomi.
So you're a huge, huge cricket fan. I mean, for you, you were kind of born with cricket in your blood, right?
Yeah, 100%.
So tonight we're out here, we're right here looking at the match. It must feel awesome to be able to be this close to the game.
I feel like I'm almost on a pitch, yeah.
I know, I saw you warming up your shoulders earlier.
Yeah.
And tell me how you feel representing Guyana in the pageant. And then this year we have, you know, a whole new set of young women vying for the title. What does cricket in Guyana mean for you?
Cricket in Guyana means unity for me. It's, as you can see from the national stadium right now.
1 second, Amel. There's a review. I'll hand it back to the comms box.
Yeah, looking to send this one upstairs. Where it pitched is important. But this one straight, in contrast to the others that went past the outside edge.
Yeah, we'll go through the protocol. It's a legal delivery. Colin Munro is batting, I would say, outside leg stump or very close to it. So you're right, where it pitches, I think it pitches outside leg. It looks as though it struck him outside leg as well. So from my initial view, this looks to be a good decision from the umpire. Let's check ultra edge. Yeah, no bat involved. So we'll go to ball tracking to see precisely where this one's pitched. It's always a little bit tough for the right-hand fast bowler bowling over the wicket to the left-handed batter. What does ball tracking have to offer? Colin Munro doesn't look to be too concerned. As a matter of fact, he's ready to go again. Yeah, pitches outside the line, as we suspected. Review lost. Decision upheld. Good decision from umpire Leslie Reefer.
Pretorius can't believe that missed the stumps. I'm with him.
I thought there was a bit of an inside edge as well. Good take from Azam Khan. An aggressive stroke from Munro down the track again. We've seen this a number of times, but that in swing, yeah, that fooled me. I thought that Azam Khan took it cleanly as well. Good bowling. Good spell so far from Pretorius. He's been good in this phase.
top over, just the wide from in terms of the score, 14-1. Three menacing overs so far from the Warriors. They've gotten something laterally and have used the angles well. He's been there on that line consistently, Shepherd. Let's go back down to Naomi Cowan.
Still standing with Amel Griffith here in the Republic Bank fan stand. The reigning Miss Cricket Carnival 2022. She's ready to hand over the crown. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
You are. And also, Amel, we were talking about what having the CPL finals means to you as a Guyanese woman, as a Guyanese sportswoman, and what does it mean to Guyana?
Of course, it means a lot to my country because this is an event that brings us all together as a people. As you can tell by the National Stadium right now, we are outside in our numbers rooting for the Guyana Amazon Warriors. And, you know, we will be celebrating in big style when we take the trophy this year.
Yeah. Okay, she's very confident. So when you were younger, Amel, would I have seen you with the bat or the ball?
Both.
Both?
Yeah,
oh, is that all wrong?
I'm better with the ball. I'm better with the ball because, yeah, the bat was never the strong suit for me.
Okay, and in the field, and you're a good fielder?
Not really.
No. And so tonight's match, nice score on the board. What do you think about that?
I'm very confident in our guys tonight. I know we will be walking away with this game. It's full celebration mode for Guyana. We win. Easy peasy. Easy peasy.
Easy peasy. Yes. The Guyanese fans are pressuring the Kings tonight, and it's quite exciting. The atmosphere is beautiful. You must come down to Providence Stadium if you can. Back to the comms box from the Republic Bank fanside.
Yeah, it looks like a lot of fun down there. Samuel, you want to go down?
Yeah, thanks to Naomi. She's always doing a wonderful job engaging with the fans and getting their emotions out. Talking about emotions, he's a happy camper. Bouncer, where's Mrs. Bouncer? In the air. No fielder there. That will land safely. It lands so safely. It's all the way for Republic Bank maximum. That's the pace of Shepherd and the risk you run if you bowl short with the fielders in.
Yeah, there's been a clear plan by Shepherd. It's the third time in the over. He's gone into the pitch quite short to Rajapaksa. That time Rajapaksa gets it over, but I think Shepherd knows he's in the game. Won't mind that too much. First Republic Bank maximum of the innings for the Kings. This is a good battle. Remember Matthew Ford bowled from this media center end to the two lefties and has went wide mainly. Shepherd has gone there a couple times but has been short. Now back wide. That easterly wind as well would assist, just praying the ball across the two lefties.
He has to bowl that tight line because of the fact that third is in the circle. And Rajapaksa is very good with that late cut and that dab down to third. Plays it very late. And Shepherd will be aware of that and continue with a tight line.
Tried to hit it across the line. Did he get there? Shimron Hetmeyer running in from that deep point boundary. We'll find out soon. 21-1.
It was his catch. He called for it early. Didn't get there in the end. Fell short of him. Valiant effort nonetheless. Did well to stop the ball as well.
Last delivery of the last over, Shimron Hetmeyer, deep point boundary. There is that breeze as well, which would have made it bit challenging. Didn't get there in the end. But they've created a few opportunities off that top edge against Rajapaksa. He's on 15, though. And Pretorius continues again. He's bowled beautifully.
Now let's see if they continue with that plan to bowl short at the Sri Lankan. Deep mid-wicket, deep backward square. His two fielders out. So the line can be predicted by the batter straight.
Another one off the edge and another boundary.
The outside off, risky. Has a slip in position. Pretorius gets the edge, but it flew off the edge of the bat and over his head. So he's edged it and it's gone for four. If he crunches it, it will also go for four because his boundary riders are leg side. So a little bit closer is where he needs to be. Does he make the adjustment in line?
Very crafty. That is excellent from Banuka Rajapaksa.
Yeah, he overcompensates. Oftentimes this happens to a bowler. You bowl wide outside off stump, you pay the price, and then you try to get a little bit straighter, but you get too straight. So consecutive boundaries off Pretorius. That will put him under a lot of pressure. He's been good in this phase, remember.
This is good. You can see the intent, at least from Rajapaksa. They're trying to go hard in this Sky Fair power play. I want to see when the power play has ended. We enter the middle phase. Spoke to Raza at the toss about it. Spoke to Sammy. Remember they got 167 for three against TKR and it wasn't enough. They want more in the middle overs. That stayed low. Pace off again from Pretorius. Almost shaved the stump.
Yeah, and hence no wide signal. Walked across his stumps and was very close to it. He's complaining, Rajapaksa, for the wide. That's not a wide. That's a very good decision from the umpire. No complaining there. These two are also crucial, Nikhil, because of their left-handedness to counter Moti and Tahir.
He's really grown in confidence, Rajapaksa. Another boundary.
Yeah, this to me is disappointing bowling. That is a free hit essentially for the batter. It's full, it's wide. There's no protection there. So he just needs to flay at that. And flay he did. Gets enough of a bat on it. Another boundary. It's been expensive. 12 runs so far from this over. Yeah, it's quite quiet at the moment. You know you're on top when you're playing the Amazon Warriors when the fans are silent.
Finally gets it right, Pretorius, but 13 from the over. 34 for one.
St. Lucia Kings, 9 runs ahead of where the Warriors were at this stage. We are at a most important stage of this tournament. Same action, same partying, same excitement, but more on the line. Kimo Paul has been in good form this Republic Bank CPL. He comes into the attack, and so does Danny Morrison.
Yeah, hi, Alex. Hi, everyone. In terms of this run chase, yeah, key juncture of this clash with Kimo Paul coming round.
Oh, struck beautifully into the offside. He's looking commanding, Rajapaksa. Could it be his innings tonight?
Well, it needs to be. He's back into the side. And in terms of being a bit of a fire starter, because we're at the top of the order, and you've got Rajapaksa having to get going, having to establish himself. They win, they get a cue next to the name to the Kings. And he wants to be part of this, does Rajapaksa, going forward.
Good reply from Kimo Paul. Well, I've been thinking up of all sorts of witty replies recently, Danny Morrison, because I've been on the CPL chat app all night. I want to say a big shout out to everyone on there this evening. You can scan that QR code or you can download the CPL chat app. All the fans and commentators I'm on tonight, we have a chat there about all the action as it's happening live during the game. It's been very interesting, in fact. Fans from all across the region and world, you get involved. Oh, clever. Just at the last minute, got a little bat on it. And another boundary.
Yeah, it's flowing, isn't it? He's looking for boundaries, and the bowlers are looking to just subtly change things up. Saw it with Pretorius, and he got his line slightly wrong. Now with Kimo Paul coming round, he's a little too wide there. And it just allows Rajapaksa to execute a little bit of a dab and pick up more.
Sharp run. Colin Munro 4 off 11. So he will be looking to tee off shortly, no doubt.
Yeah, just, well, this is the last, isn't it? Last over the power play. And then you've got the skipper himself, Imrintar here, looking to go top of the tree in terms of wickets for a bit of spin at this particular venue.
Really well bowled. Looking so good, Kimo Paul. I don't just mean the hairstyle, which is beautiful. He's just been in form with bat and ball.
Those who are not follically challenged.
From Saxakali in the Essequibo, Kimo Paul. Yeah, indeed. All of Guyana will be urging him on this evening. Well, that's blunted down the ground. Belligerent from Colin Munro, who wants to seam up the end of the Sky Fair power play nicely. He does that, 47 for one. So a relative win for the St. Lucia Kings in that Sky Fair power play. Key number there in that Tezo insight is the 16 to 20. 72 runs the Warriors were able to score in the death. The skipper, Imrintar here. Iconic. He's been fantastic leading this side this season. And that's beaten the fielder. Should be just a single, though.
Yeah, as per, whether it's the skipper or just spin. After the power play, you've got more men out, of course, and appreciate that. That allows the spinners to have their say. Yeah, just been told to get off the danger area there in your follow through, please, Imran. Watch that. Oi. He didn't follow through on that occasion. Other times, he's quite animated, gets through the crease. But this time it was told, behave yourself, skip.
You'll remember the beginning of this tournament, St. Lucia Kings lost a couple of games at the top of the tournament from rain and bad weather. Looking to make them up now. Looking for a couple of points. This one, oh, there's a fielder on it. Oh, he's dropped it. He can't believe it, Pretorius. That is an opportunity missed early on in this innings.
Yeah, and he apologises to his captain because really, this has got to be taken, well, 11 times out of 10. Just mistimed his jump. Pretorius, and then I tell you what, just notice there with his feet planting in the turf, could have easily done something nasty to a knee, but still, bad miss.
Almost didn't need to jump. The ball was coming right towards him.
Yeah, it's one of those tricky ones. You're not quite sure. The backdrop of stadiums, sometimes the crowd. Yeah, when up like that, I know that horrible feeling when you do jump and you don't need to and you mistime it and you don't take the catch, and it really is a bad miss. How bad a miss? Now, let's wait and see. Crucial, and you think Rajapaksa is in a lovely groove here, striking at 180.
Yeah, he can see himself, can't he, on the screen. Four for one. 167 for five was the Guyana Amazon Warriors effort. Good knock from Azam Khan, 40 off just 25. And St. Lucia King's response so far, 54 for one after seven. Omega XL Skycam giving us these breathtaking vistas of Guyana, Georgetown, Providence, the surrounding areas. Can see far and wide. We'll be hitting that town tonight, Danny, for the biggest party in sport.
Well, you might be, because you're quite a bit younger.
Oh, come on, Danny. They know you by now. We've got a day off tomorrow. Absolutely, we got to hit the town tonight.
Well, you don't have to. The stadium establishment's just across the way, their own party. In fact, everyone just making their own street party here. It's wonderful to see it. It's such a great vibe here. And as we know, the Guyanese fans, they get amongst it.
They sure do. There are a few bars right across the road here from this Guyana National Stadium that look ready for us, shall I say? So they've gone 42 without loss the last 30 balls. This is a 50-run partnership. That's up now. 50 runs off this partnership between Rajapaksa and Monroe. So a good stand here by the Kings in this chase.
Yeah, and substantially dominated by Rajapaksa. He's had the lion's share of the strike. And when you do, now you need to show your worth. And Rajapaksa is tonight with his 44 from 25 there. Eight fours and a maximum. He's off strike. And so Muntahi is just listening and chatting with Kemo Paul. And KP's just saying, look, I need you back there, Skip. Could you pop back to long off? Long on's in. Point on the fence as well. The other thing is the dew factor. I just wonder how thick it will get. It is an element here. We know that. And I think that's why, in terms of winning the toss, Simrantar here, wanting to bat first and have a crack at it, because then you're in the playoffs and you may not have a choice. And that you've got to bat first and you've got to post a total and cope with the dew bowling second.
Yeah, we'll fill the Guyana Amazon Warriors fans with some comfort, having the opportunity to try out a few things. Oh, launched! That's an absolute beauty and a Republic Bank maximum.
Yeah, they're loving it in the dugout, the Blues. It's his 50 for Rajapaksa, the Sri Lankan pocket rocket. And he's a lefty too.
thought for a moment this ball may challenge the Omega Skycam. It went so high up, but it also went the distance to bring up his half century. Very good for Banuka Rajapaksa and the St. Lucia Kings.
There's no slower ball there. That last or previous one to bring up his 50 was a little leg cutter from Kimo Paul, but no such there. He ran in and really hit the deck hard, and it fizzed on through to Azim Khan. So, yeah, as I just love this cat and mouse about T20. What's coming next, given that you've either disappeared or you've bowled a couple of good seeds? Another one.
Yeah, it's been a good comeback from Kimo Paul. A couple of dots after that big maximum. Ooh, who's that? Oh, it's the CPL fan of the match, and they've got a TCL voucher, $500. Is it Darth Vader? Darth Vader with a... This guy is armed and dangerous. Do not mess with him, Danny.
Looks like a pop gun. That's it, the popcorn gun. Feeding everyone. Oh, three in a row. What a ripper. Overstarted expensively, finished it well, did KP. 8 done, 62 for 1.
Well, the St. Lucia Kings going on very nicely here, having lost Johnson Charles in the second over. Nice partnership, 57 runs off it between Rajapaksa and Munro. Tahir back in to his work. Yeah, an easy two. Oh! Hello there. Zinger's up. Let's have a look at this.
Nigel Duguid, television third up. I think he's home safely, but dear old Nige. Yeah, it's comfortable. I'd just like to make sure, just in case the bat hasn't been slid. But yeah, do love the zingers once the sun's gone down.
They've been good, the Warriors in the field, in terms of direct hits. Ooh. Imran Tahir, what a performer. What an entertainer. Look at his response here.
Yeah, hard on his sleeve, isn't he? What a beauty. At length.
Oh, he's lucky there. Colin Munro will pick up a couple.
Just lives every ball, does Imran Tahir. Whips out the celebrations, runs off as if he's scored the winning goal in the FIFA World Cup final. And then all the drama when he bowls a couple of good deliveries, hams it up to the crowd. They love it.
Yeah, totally entertaining to watch, to be fair. The odds going with the Kings at the minute, but we know what this game is like. And the Warriors, as we've discussed, have given themselves some added difficulty here. Chose to bat first, knew about the due. Giving it a go. Safely at the top of the Republic Bank table, they are. Oh, that's a lovely shot. It will be very difficult to stop, and no one will. Colin Munro getting involved now. And a little fun at the boundary.
Yeah, with those two high-fiving, I was a little concerned that maybe they crunched into each other. It was only one winner there with the ball. So good in that region, Colin Munro. Down on one knee, slog sweep. Hetmeyer. Traffic. Gentlemen. A couple of big units there. Is that Shep? Shepherd and Hetmeyer. Do not want to head on.
Who's winning that collision?
Exactly.
That one lofted up. Just dropped short. Pretorius again. That one was more difficult, spinning away, Danny.
Well, I just think cricket's like that, isn't it? The ball on some afternoons or evenings will follow you. You put one down, and it's got a cruel habit of doing this, where it's teasing. Yeah, it was always just a little too far. Look at him. Brilliant.
El Dorado celebration ahead of time. What a skipper. What a ripper. 10 off it. 9 gone. 72 for 1. St. Lucia Kings well on track here. Required rate 8.73. They're currently going at eights. Just the loss of one wicket. They'll feel pretty comfortable at this stage in terms of this chase.
Yeah, time for the bustler, hustler, Odine Smith. Bustling short runner. Man, it looks more like a rugby prop than a cricketer. Look at the state of him. Just warming up, getting lubed and limbered. Yeah, he just goes for too many, and he knows that. Often bowling the middle stages or the death, the final overs, and so just tends to be slightly off with the radar and the options, you sometimes wonder. But he'll hustle in there. Rajapaksa, he's got 50, needs to kick on here. The Kings want Rajapaksa to get 80 or 90 here and nail the job.
Oh, stunning, flicked it away. And another Republic Bank maximum. Well, he's well on his way and he's in a hurry.
Yeah, he's off to catch a train, isn't he? He's going like one himself. Yeah, it's that line again from Odine Smith. It's not the start he was hoping for because it's all about getting confidence as a bowler and just getting the first couple out the way nice and tidy as dot balls. But now he's under the pump here as Odine Smith at the start of his opening over.
And a hush has fallen around Providence. It's looking really nice. Rajapaksa.
Maiden CPL 50 for the Sri Lankan. Great at using the pace and manipulating. A little bit of luck, a couple of top edges, one there over slip, but it was a flashing blade. And they do say if you flash, flash hard. Lovely free flow of the blade. And when he's on song, he's useful. That's not bad either. It's a wide, don't mind that. As long as it's, you know, humming through, maybe causing the batter problems. But this 50, yeah, just what the Kings needed here in this crunch game for them.
Yeah, and dare I say what Banuka Rajapaksa needed as well. Strong behind square, that shows us. He'll need it for his own confidence, going at 181 at the minute. Yes. Colin Munro as well. Coming to the party, just playing a supportive role.
Well, he might have his hands on his hips here, Odine Smith, but if you're coming right arm around to the lefties, you cannot bowl that straight. Have to be outside the off stump. Look at this line. No, not at all. And so with fine leg up, even more so, sacrilege from Odine.
Yeah, it was just a little tickle around the corner for Munro. And a little pressure here on Odine Smith, 12 off the over, 3 to bowl. Over the wicket.
Yeah, a bit of Rerio.com in terms of buying official CPL player cards. Go to Rerio.com and I think Rajapaksa, he'll be on your list there. Guys to score with Rerio player cards.com. Get in there.
Yeah, swap them with your friends.
It's humming too. It's about Odin in terms of learning his craft of when to bowl with pace on and when to bowl with pace off change-ups, and then also whether you go round, whether you go over, just finding that confidence. He still just lacks that a little, I believe.
Oh, dear. And it finishes as it began. Another 6, 19 from it. And at the halfway point, the St. Lucia Kings, 91 for 1. Time for our Angostura chill moment here.
91 for 1 here at Providence Stadium in pursuit of that 168 to try to win the game for the Kings to book themselves a place in the playoffs. Rajapaksa has gone quickly, coming back into the team tonight, Samuel Battery.
Yes, a flurry of boundaries from Rajapaksa, not altogether convincing, but it doesn't matter. He's raced along 64 unbeaten from just 34 deliveries. 8 fours and 4 sixes along the way. So it's a welcome return to form from him. Remember, this is an important game for the Kings. They win this and they book themselves a place in the top four. Only success so far from Romario Shepherd in his first over, first ball. Tonight picked up the wicket of Johnson Charles, but since then, it's been all Rajapaksa and Munro. At this stage of the innings, the most fantasy points for Dream 11. Banuka Rajapaksa, 98. Azam Khan, remember his innings, 62 points. Alzari Joseph, Shea Hope, and Romario Shepherd round off the top five.
Gulakesh Moti into the attack. Big side of the ground on the leg side to these two left-handers. Munro going at just a run a ball. He really has tried to power the ball more often, but his timing has been off tonight.
And what does the Guyana Amazon Warriors take from this contest? What learnings can they glean at the toss? Remember, they wanted to challenge themselves bowling second. They had to set a total, therefore, what did they learn from that innings? And what are they learning here?
Say it again, what they learned from that innings is that they need to be more aggressive at certain points. Stuck himself there, Tahir. Some people in the house have just been chilling the Angostura refreshing moment award winner. $200 US always comes in handy. Terrific. Taking on the matchup. He's taking on anyone tonight, Rajapaksa.
Yeah, and it brings up the 100 for the St. Lucia Kings, and he's done it in some style. Just a shimmy down the track and as straight as you can get. A wonderful swing off the bat from Rajapaksa. He's middle most of them tonight. It's been a sublime innings from him. Remember, he didn't play for a few games. Come back. This has been just a single.
He's middle one. They're tearing into the left-hand spin as left-handed batters. They're taking on this favorable matchup.
And as they should, that one has gone into orbit. A monstrous strike from Colin Munro. And it was, dropped in the crowd. Almost a bet batter catch. Not to be.
Don't think that's the place for a 44-year-old to be fielding at backward point. 109 for one. Imran Tahir, none for 17 from two. Big side of the ground. Junior Sinclair does the cleaning up. He's a superb fielder. His run out of Ruffman Powell against the Royals was outstanding.
The last over, almost a bet batter catch in the crowd. It needs to be one-handed. Let's have a close look. Almost, just bubbled it. It's worth $1,000 US at this stage of the tournament. And when we enter the playoffs, listen to this, folks, $5,000 if caught in the mound.
I can safely say to my director and producer that during the playoffs, when I'm not on commentary, you know where to find me. I'll be sitting in the mound. Danny and I, and we'll be practicing our catching. Morrison says he'll be on my shoulders.
And 56 needed from 50 deliveries, 9 wickets in hand. St. Lucia Kings, they've got some support in the house. vastly outnumbered, but they're still cheering their team on.
Kept low. It's St. Lucia's best partnership this season. And it's not been an easy surface, as that last delivery emphasizes a number of deliveries. The bounce has been variable, but huge game for these guys to seal a playoff spot if they can. .114 for 1.
They've come in their numbers last night. They're in their numbers tonight again. Waving the national flag of Guyana proudly, urging their team on. In a precarious position tonight, but they've been excellent throughout so far.
They're very proud of their franchise here in Guyana, but there is obviously a fondness for the Amazon Warriors beyond the borders of this country. Very popular franchise, and many of them, they've espoused the fact they hope that this year is the year that they can lay their hands on the Republic Bank CPL trophy. Kimo Paul. Republic Bank player of the day. Matthew Ford taking the wicket of Shea Hope. He's a good cricketer, I'll say it again. So much potential. And very, very articulate and eloquent when he speaks. Breaks down the game beautifully. Well, he's a fast bowler, you have to expect that. No ball now. So a free hit.
Yeah, the wheels are falling off now for the Guyana Amazon Warriors. Colin Monroe will be the lucky recipient of this free hit. An opportunity for him to get that strike rate up a little bit more. Yeah, good call from the umpire. Confirmation of that no ball. Can he capitalize on this free hit? Very well executed yorker from Kimo Paul. One of the things that the Guyana Amazon Warriors will no doubt learn from this contest as well is the fact that they can include an off spinner in their lineup against these guys who are left-handed heavy. Yeah, full toss, gentle full toss from Kimo Paul. And Rajapaksa is in no mood to miss out. Opens the face of the bat on contact and beats the fielder in the deep. A wonderful strike from the southpaw.
He's been a good selection tonight, coming back into the team. They went for the under 23 player in McKenny Clark, which allowed them the opportunity to play an extra overseas player. And he's certainly made his presence felt. And this is how he plays generally. Teams who hire him talk about him going hard from the word go. Him over. Kimo Paul has been outstanding, pace off. a slight struggle for Monroe tonight. He wasn't as fluent as he would hope. They're celebrating.
Now there'll be a check for that front foot no ball from Kimo Paul. Yeah, he grimaces there. It will be a great disappointment if it is. And it is. Sad news for Kimo Paul and the Guyana Amazon Warriors. Not only is it not a wicket, it's also going to be a free hit. So Christmas has come early for Colin Monroe. Partnership now 119 of 73. So another opportunity for Colin Monroe to capitalize on a free hit in this over. What a shame from Kimo Paul. An excellent delivery, slower ball on target, but just couldn't keep that front foot behind the line. Celebration short-lived.
Come on, Colin. Oh, Colin. Yeah, I think that, and it's better it happens now for the Amazon Warriors, given that they've already qualified in the top two. They were fortunate against the Barbados Royals. The Barbados Royals should have gotten six off the last over, nine times out of ten. So they've got to try to maximize even more their batting, whether they, when they're batting first. I think that's a big thing. They've got too much firepower. I want to see Shea Hope be a little more aggressive in the way he plays. And they've been a good fielding team generally. Pretorius, one fell short of him. He put down a catch as well.
.127 for 113 gone. Dwayne Pretorius into the attack for his final over. This is the opportunity that we're talking about. Pretorius, the man who put the catch down, and you can see the disappointment. Rajapaksa, the beneficiary of that grasped opportunity. Yeah, 12 dots from Pretorius from 18 deliveries. Can he find a wicket?
Instead, what he can find is a gap. Colin Monroe, this will do him the world of good. Hasn't been his most fluent innings, but Rajapaksa has taken any burden off of him by batting so quickly.
Yeah, slow ball, but with an offer. And the precision of the stroke is quite commendable. Played it late to get it in the gap. Yeah, this outfield is lightning fast. Oftentimes, he started his over with a boundary in Guyana so far.
Thank you.
Yeah, these two have generally made batting look easy. Very enterprising from the get-go from Rajapaksa. Less so from Monroe. But they're getting the job done. It's so different when you're chasing and you know what the score is, as opposed to when you're batting first and setting.
He is mishitting the ball with such precision tonight. Really is struggling for his timing, but some innings are just like that. And as you said, the fact that he's chasing and Rajapaksa has alleviated any pressure that he might be feeling. This is superb from Rajapaksa, helping Monroe. It was a struggle at the start for Rajapaksa as well, but then he started getting a feel of conditions.
Yeah, not getting the middle of the bat in the initial part of the innings, and sometimes it's just like that. And then you get going and you make it count. It's been a day for Sri Lanka, hasn't it? First, their national team winning in the Asia Cup. Another Rajapaksa making tonight his own here in Guyana. 14 gone, 134 for one.
Yeah, that game between Pakistan and Sri Lanka today was a thrilling contest. The crowds there at the Premadasa Stadium in Colombo were, it was hair-raising the way they were chanting and cheering every run of their national team. Memorable. Weather in Guyana has been outstanding, so we've had rich entertainment. Well ahead, well ahead, the St. Lucia Kings. More cricket of the Republic Bank CPL coming up this weekend on Saturday. After a day off tomorrow here at the National Stadium in Providence, the Talawas searching for a win. They've lost five on the trot. The Patriots cannot get to the playoffs, but they're looking to back up their win from the last game. I wonder if Fletcher's fit. And then a preview of qualifier one between the Warriors and TKR. This time, no. Oh, goodness.
Yeah, the mishits have been placed superbly throughout the course of the night from both Monroe and Rajapaksa, to be fair. Falling safely once again. Yeah, that qualifier one between the Guyana Amazon Warriors and the Trinbago Knight Riders. Potentially, those two can face each other four times this season.
Not hit it well enough. Shimron Hetmeyer takes the catch. It's the bigger side of the boundary. And that extra 4 or 5 meters or so. Oh, no, not again. Surely not a no ball again. That would be the ultimate sin, if it is. They don't know yet. We don't know yet. We will know now. Nah, it's good.
Yeah, something behind the line this time from Kimo Paul. And he will be rewarded for his efforts. Just a flick of the wrist, but the timing wasn't as good as it has been so far. The bigger side of the ground, Hetmeyer has a safe pair of hands. He made that catch look easy. Rajapaksa made this innings look easy. 86 from 49, 137 for two.
Sean Williams, who has played decently this season, played well certainly in the last game. You have to give Rajapaksa a lot of credit. I give him a lot of credit because in the last game, I thought the Kings lacked intent in their batting from too many players. He's come in tonight and he's given them that aggression, that intent that you need to have in T20 cricket batting. Good work from Junior Sinclair. He's very quick across the ground.
Remember too, folks, that the St. Lucia Kings, they have five overseas in their playing 11 tonight because of that emerging player rule, McKennie Clark in. So they're allowed to do that in this contest.
And they did it in the first game of the season as well. So a successful over 29 to get from the last five. 139 for two. Imran Tahir, skipper, need wickets, the Warriors. Has he got enough, Munro? Yes, he has, just enough. And the 50's up as well for Colin Munro. First 50 at this venue in 9 innings. It's been a struggle, but sometimes you have to grind it out. He's done just that.
Good on you, Colin. Munro, yeah, he wanted to give it some, and he did. And again, now that is a classier stroke over extra. Really nice stroke that. 6-4 to start the 16th, and they're humming along here of those in blue. He's looking to go top of the tree. I mentioned a while ago, he's up there with Sunil Narine as Imran Tahir in terms of the most wickets taken by a bowler at this venue. Hasn't got one yet tonight, and he's in his last roll of the dice as the skipper.
And Danny, I want to agree with what Ian Bishop was saying in that middle phase about Munro. It's been a real struggle, but given all of the context, the run chase, knowing exactly what they need, Rajapaksa at the other end going well, but also that he struck at 98 before this innings at Providence. It's been a struggle for some reason here. He toughed it out and he's got them very close to the playoffs. And as soon as I say that, wicket has to depart, but you could say the job has been done.
Yeah, I'll subscribe to that, Nicholas. Nicholas Uttam Chandani, have to agree. And Imran Tahir right on cue. He's only got one ball left. He's top of the tree now. Most wickets taken at Providence by a bowler here in Guyana. The end of Munro at a half century. Might not be his most fluent, but it's helped the cause. 149 for three here.
Okay.
Sikander Raza, the captain. Team Lini need less than 20. And remember, folks, one win, just one win, gets them into that top four and safe for now. Oh, how is that? Looks good. Tahir, I think, is animated. He sent it upstairs already. Obviously, if he got bad on it, he's safe. If not, deep trouble.
Yeah, there's the signal from Mr. Butler from St. Vincent. Time for Nigel Duguid to get the goggles on. Through the protocols, front foot first. Needed to hit this, did the skipper. Captain v. Cap, did he glove it? Bat or glove? Those are very difficult in terms of bowlers getting excited or even umpires. Down the line like that. See, it's front on. Back gets in the way a little bit. Watching. Is it bat or glove? It's the glove, is it? Yeah, just the glove there. Yeah, glove just gets a bit of movement in the replay here on Ultra Edge. So, Dayton Butler, you little beauty! He's all over it with the enhancers, the eyewear. Imran, take it easy. Ends the over. 16 done, it's 151 for three.
Guyana Warriors, the Amazon Warriors have lost their reviews. Modi. From the other end. Yeah, he likes that reverse sweep. We've seen it many times, but didn't make any contact. Chase is on. Oh, think he does well in the end.
Is it a bit barter super safe from the bruiser, Odin Smith? And they're just going to have Nigel Duguid. Does he want to have a look at this? Oh, some of the chaps tonight, the hands aren't working, but the feet are. Yes. Smithers. Yeah, a little tiptoe through the tulips for the big guy. Saves it. So, yeah, three byes in the end. With that attempted bit of improvising from the skipper.
Yeah, Danny, I'm looking at this Warriors bowling lineup, the makeup of it. I'm thinking about a night maybe when you play TKR, who they'll play on Tuesday in that first qualifier. You've got Puran as a left-hander. If he goes deep, you have Moti as a left-arm spinner. You've got Tahir as the leg spinner. Goes through extra cover. That is powerful.
Yeah, that's a bit of the old buffet bowling here from Moti. Half tracker that really does deserve the treatment it got. Way too easy for Raza. And it just brings that asking need down to 10 now from 21. Delighted the Kings. They needed a win to get into the playoffs, and they're doing it here tonight in style.
Just held up a touch. Oh, it's gone through him. Shepherd can't believe it. He's put in all the effort. This has probably been the worst fielding performance from the Warriors. They've been the best team by far.
I'd like you to go down and tell those big guys tonight that's been it. We're sending Nickel down to do a post-match. But yeah, in agreement. Victorious. Think about Odin Smith. Oh, body on the line. Wonderful commitment. Can't say it hasn't been that. Brilliant there from a Mario Shepherd, but in the end, couldn't prevent the boundary. Back to back, 11 off. Just six required now.
Yeah, but just to that point, Danny, I just wonder if there will be consideration maybe to an off spinner of Junior Sinclair or Kevin Sinclair, both in their side. Someone that can provide a point of difference, because Odin Smith last night, 3 overs for 33 runs, that is. Tonight, 1 over for 19.
He's not been at his best, has to be said, Odin Smith. Yeah, he's just not really got out of second gear, Smith. And that's easy, in control. So when you think about things going forward, lots to think about. 17 bowl, Kings, 164 for three here.
Just four away, this Kings team from securing a win and securing a place in the Republic Bank CPL playoff. Saim Ayoub off the field with a groin injury. Saw Brandon King off the field last night for the entirety of the innings with a groin injury. So we hope, especially for the Warriors' sake, they hope that he can recover quickly. Got a game, two games coming thick and fast. They can rest, of course, Danny. Have the luxury of being in the top two. Odin Smith just called his name. We'll want to get a wicket at least before this game is over.
Yeah, when you pick up those niggles at the wrong time, and of course we're into the playoffs next week, and you're the home side, yeah, you got to play pretty much every day that you're at home and your venue. So with the Trinbago Knight Riders, they come thick and fast, game's on. Double headers on the weekend for the Warriors here Saturday, Sunday. So just about your point making, yeah, top of the tree, you finish in the top two, so you get that extra bite of the cherry, as it were, to then allow guys being rested. So, yeah, confirmation there. The Warriors and Knight Riders finishing 1-2. Kings win here tonight. They get a Q next to their name. And so that'll confirm the Kings for third. But, yeah, it allows some of the Warriors to have a bit of a rest. Oh, dear. Emmy! I think that'll be it. That's going to get into the fence now. Winning runs to the boys in blue, and they're out of the dugout, and smiles starting to appear on those faces.
First loss for the Guyana Amazon Warriors this season, but they won't mind. A lot of learnings for Imran Tahir and his team. Home crowd will be disappointed, but for Sikandar Raza and the Kings, finally a return to winning ways. Sami and Raza both asked for more impetus in the middle. They kept the Warriors to just six and over when they bowled, and with the bat in hand, Rajapaksa took the game away. A very versatile team with depth, the Kings. Could do some damage in those playoffs, but happy faces, smiles. This tournament can be gruesome. It's relieving to get into those playoffs.
Yeah, it's a bit of a habit, isn't it? Winning becomes a habit, and then so does losing. You get into a rut, and it feels sometimes it's impossible to get out of. And that'll be very, very pleasing for Sikandar Raza, Darren Sammy, and the St. Lucia Kings, given they lost their original skipper, and Faf du Plessis, who's one of those inspiring leaders through all his experience and performance, of course. But Faf had to go home and have some surgery on that forearm elbow. Now, yeah, got another good leader and a replacement for Faf is Sikandar Raza, very good all-round cricketer, and, helping inspire this team. Darren Sammy, you see, he's got a few aches and pains himself. I said, mate, get the nets and roll your arm over. He said, not with this back and these knees, Danny. So pleased for Darren Sammy and the St. Lucia Kings here, now confirming their qualification for the playoffs.
Azari Joseph there at the front of the line, and he deserves a lot of credit. He quietly picks up 2 to 3 wickets every single night, bowls the tough overs, and his pace has been exhilarating.
with this Kings team, with the options and different bowling types that they have, they get that batting right, which has failed them in the last couple of games. They're a tough team to beat, you know. Now three teams in the playoffs. One more left. Rajapaksa was amazing, to say the least. Started a bit slow, but was able to get that strike rate closer to 180. Munro, it was a big struggle for him, but he supported Rajapaksa well, and in the situation and context of the chase, did what was required to get them to 170. And fitting for Raza, who bowled well and now has batted well to finish the game.
Yeah, and on the flip side, in terms of bowling, yeah, just not enough wickets. You got to get wickets early, and just wasn't to be. Pretorius, he missed out. Tahir got one in the end, so did Kimo Paul, but yeah, he bowled a no ball and should have knocked over Munro earlier. Shepherd, whilst he got a wicket, the others couldn't get amongst it early enough to cause problems. Just Johnson Charles out early to Romario Shepherd. That was it.
Yeah, Rajapaksa will be overjoyed. Hasn't been in the last international series, but a return to the team and a return to runs for the Kings. The Warriors, they'll think about that middle phase. Could we be faster? Ian Bishop wants them to be faster. Have the luxury of experimenting in the next two games. They're in the top two. The Kings joined them in the playoffs. Win by 7 wickets. So many exciting performances, but Banuka Rajapaksa standing out. Only picked by 7% of you. Credit to you, Dream 11 users, who knew he would come good tonight. And boy, he did that.
Yeah, a return to form, a return to the side, and so fluent when pace is on the ball and just clipping and chipping. And then the lovely uppercuts to the Dream 11 most valuable player, and Banuka Rajapaksa from Sri Lanka. Wonderful wrist work and the timing for all to appreciate from this very talented striker of the cricket ball.
Dream 11 most fantasy points. Munro was steady and effective as Amkhan with some firepower, but Rajapaksa leading the way with 123 points. Let's go down to Alex Jordan.
All right, it's time for the Player of the Match Award, and tonight it's presented by Mr. Vastio Singh, who is the CEO of Demerara Distillers Limited. They're the bottlers of Eldorado rum. Great to have him here. And of course, the Player of the Match goes to Banuka Rajapaksa for his wonderful 86 off 49 balls. A match-winning knock. He'll get his check here, shake a hand, smile for the camera, and come and have a quick chat with us. Thank you very much, Mr. Singh. Banuka, congratulations. You came good on a night to get your team into the playoffs. How much did your national team's performance today in the Asia Cup inspire you?
First of all, praise the Lord for the wisdom and favor, you know. But, you know, before talking about the match here, it's always thrilling when Sri Lankans play and win. We made a match out of nowhere. It's always nice to, you know, give money's worth to the spectators. And we're quite happy because we qualified for the second consecutive time.
Yeah, very exciting moment. Let's talk about your knock. It was fantastic. You know, you went after everything. What worked for you today?
See, before the match, Sammy spoke to me and said, you know, just go and give me a good knock to remember. So I think it's a September to be remembered, and started off the month quite well for me because I played the game after 2 weeks and I was quite fresh. But, you know, it was all Sammy's instruction for me to go and, you know, just go at it.
It means a qualification now for the St. Lucia Kings into the playoffs. How is the vibe in the camp? What's the word from your management?
You know, it has always been nice. You know, we had a proper vibe and the team has been quite united. And we knew that we just needed 2 points out of the 2 games. So, and it's quite, you know, happy. I'm quite happy because we got it before the last game we are going to face against Jamaica.
I think you play again on Sunday against that same Jamaica Talawas. That's the final of the Asia Cup too. What are you going to do?
Of course, I'll be... I mean, the timings are different, but hopefully I could, you know, keep up the score with the manager and have a look at the score. And as long as we keep winning over here, that's more important now.
Congratulations on finding some good form right when you need it.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, Banuka. What an innings it was. And his knock of 85 has meant that the Kings have got a queue placed next to their names. They'll wait for either the Royals or Talawas to play in that eliminator. and it'll be win or go home again for them. So every game from here on in, barring that last one, could be knockout. So much to consider. We'll hear from the captain soon, but first, a break. The winning moment for the St. Lucia Kings has been a roller coaster ride for them. But Sikandar Raza, Darren Sami, and the team can breathe a sigh of relief. They're in the playoffs of the Republic Bank Caribbean Premier League and can challenge for the title. Let's go down to Ian Bishop, who has the captains.
Yes, welcome to the presentation and congratulations to the St. Lucia Kings who have now made it to the playoffs. I've got the Ghana Amazon Warriors captain Imran Tah here with me and a huge reverb goes around the ground. Imran, in what has been a very successful season so far for you guys, first loss of the season, what do you attribute it to?
Yeah, look, that's what we want to be in the situation like that. You know, that's why we chose to bat first. We know the conditions due is going to later on help the batting, whoever batting second. But look, you know, there's nothing to be worried about it. But I still think that we always need to improve. And that's how we play the wonderful any sport. So for going forward, I think this is a good thing for us that we got put in the situation today. I just think that we just didn't bowl well with the plan, and that's the only concern I think if I look at so far. But other than that, look, I'm very happy. We wanted to achieve what we achieved, and you know, we were just thinking that we can try something different and then just be ready to challenge if we put in the situation like that today.
That's fair enough. So you put this squarely at the feet of the bowling from what you said there just now. Is there any area of the batting that you feel can be better?
Look, the pitch even yesterday, the played a little bit up and down, I think, and it was the same thing today, and I think earlier it was a little bit drier, so the spinners were getting a little bit more help than in the second inning. But look, that's what the challenge we all need to face as a batter and as a bowler. So something we wanted to do a homework about it, and you know, I'm glad that we did that and it's out of the way. But yeah, there is definitely room for improvement. If we put a situation like that again, we need to come with a better plan.
Saim Ayub wasn't on the field for a good after batting. Give us an update on his situation.
Yeah, he's got a little bit groin, I think, issue, but I think he should be fine. I think he needs a little bit rest. He's been a fantastic player for us. So we're just going to assess and see what physio says. And if obviously we think that he needs rest, we give him rest.
And just finally, the Guyana Amazon Warriors fans, not accustomed to losing this season, can you assure them that you're going to continue playing hard next game or two?
No, definitely, yes, yeah. Even like today's game, you know, we tried our best, but the thing is that we know that the conditions were going to be a little bit easier second inning, but it's fine. You know, it's one of those things where we learn, and I think we just need to go back and then, you know, plan for the next game and ready for the situation if you put it again like that.
Thanks for your time. Rest well tomorrow.
Thank you very much. Thanks.
Imran Tahir, the captain, the leader of the Guyana Amazon Warriors. We're going to get Sikander Raza, the captain of the St. Lucia Kings, to come in here now. Sikander, in the playoffs, how do you feel?
Yeah, I feel a little bit relieved. I think you always wanted to be in a position where you don't have to play a do-and-die game, especially the last match of the group stages. But alhamdulillah, we believed in ourselves and the team we had. The losses we had were always very close. So what we wanted to address was that if we can control the extras in the game, because that's an extra batter batting for the opposition, if we can control our extras, we should have a good chance in every game we play.
Sum up that bowling effort, guys, like Ford and Alzari Joseph, and what they are bringing to this unit.
As you can say, Alzari is just bringing heat after heat. I mean, there's no substitute for pace on a wicket like that. The one end was skidding and one was staying slightly slow, but I thought Aljari adjusted his length really well. A couple of bad balls doesn't define a whole spell. I thought Aljari ball, especially with a wet ball, and also it's very easy to look at the stats and judge a player, but we always ask Aljari to bowl the most important overs of the game, critical overs of the game. So I thought he did really well. 40 has been brilliant with a new ball, but today we trusted him with an old ball as well, and that breakthrough of Shai Hope was very, very important for us.
And Rajapaksa bringing that aggression, how critical was that?
Unbelievable. I mean, we've been trying our level best to get him in the game, but unfortunately, the guys who came to the tournament earlier has been batting so well. Our batting effort has been superb, so it has been really difficult. But alhamdulillah, we got Bhanu in the game today, and he was superb today. What an absolute beautiful inning to watch.
Given the conditions that I'm seeing here now with this due formation, teams chasing have won twice here, is it just going to be a no-brainer at the toss here for the rest of this tournament, win the toss and bowl first?
Yeah, listen, even when we were bowling, the last 8 overs were difficult to bowl, the dew was setting in. So the first 10 to 12 overs, the ball was dry, but suddenly I felt when I was trying to shine the ball or pass the ball to our bowlers from 13 over to 20, the dew was starting to play a huge factor. So yeah, dew is going to play a huge factor here. But if I was in the position of Guyana and qualified and be confident of finish number 1 and 2, I would have batted first as well, so that in case we have to bat first in an eliminator or a playoff or the final, our bowlers, our batters must know what works under lies with the due conditions.
Great minds think alike. Thank you very much for your time and congratulations.
Thank you very much.
Great to see a smiling Sikander Raza. He'll be proud of his team, the way that they've battled in a war of attrition. They needed to win this game to qualify for the playoffs, and they did just that. The batting came to the fore, well supported by their bowlers initially. But Rajapaksa, the standout with his 86. The Talawas fly into the playoffs. Kings, correction. And just to illustrate that, the Kings third on the table. It means now that they will qualify, but remember, they must be third. They cannot get into that top two, which is occupied by the Warriors and the Knight Riders. And just one spot for the Talawas and Royals to fight for. day off tomorrow. And then Saturday, we come hard. It's a double header for you. The Talawas up against the Patriots. The Talawas need to win that game. And later in the evening, the Amazon Warriors and Knight Riders, a preview of what we will see in that qualifier one game. That will be an exciting affair as well. The action has been brilliant. Your company has been brilliant. We'll see you soon. Good night.